you're rooting for the Crusaders tonight, your team's going to win. It just matters which particular team is going to win tonight, because both teams that are playing are Crusaders. It's Bishop McDevitt tonight against Lancaster Catholic in a great interleague matchup. You're going to be watching it all here tonight on High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27, brought to you tonight by the Pennsylvania Housing Finance Agency. Good evening. I'm Gary Sutton. Alongside of me is Jeff Thompson, a great coach, coaching over Cumberland Valley right now. But Jeff, when you talk about these teams tonight, first of all, talking about the girls at the opening of the doubleheader, we're talking about a Lancaster Catholic team that already has won their league. They're 11-0 in the league. They've won 75 straight league games. They're 12-2 in the season. But this is the fourth game they played this week, and the previous three they've won by a total of 5 points going to, against Section 3. They're in Section 4, the Lancaster 11 in league. They got a busy night here bringing Bishop McDevitt in, right?
Well, that can go both ways. They can be either be tested and ready to go, or they could be a little fatigued. And we'll see very shortly.
One of the people, it seems like she's been playing here forever, is Erin Holt. She averages about 9 points a game, and she is a threat from downtown.
She can hit it. Checking the statistics over the years, she's really been shooting the long ball very well.
The first year in about 100 years that Lamar Kaufman has not been coaching here. But the guy that stepped in, Lamar is from Columbia, just down the road here, is another Columbia person, Charlie Detz, who played for Glenn Robinson at F&M. And he certainly knows what he's doing, apparently, because he's won the league as early as they've ever won it.
He sure should. He's a big drink of water, and he was a very effective post player down in F&M for Glenn.
On the other side, you got a Bishop McDevitt team that's lost their last two. They're 6-7 on the season out of the Mid-Penn Keystone Division, which is a tough division this year. And when you talk about them, who do you look at right away that's going to step out and score tonight?
Well, Lauren Purcell is their main scorer. She's been carrying the bulk of their scoring all year. But they also have a good three-point shooter, Rachel Corrigan.
Rachel Corrigan is one of those girls that she can fill it up. She gets going. She is an absolute streak shooter and can nail it all night long on you.
Well, she can certainly do that. What I'm intrigued in is their longtime coach, Joe Bressy's back in the fold at McDevitt. And he thinks he's had something going here. He said he's won three times as many games this year as last year. So I'm kind of intrigued to see him and his team play.
One of the sleepers tonight inside for Bishop McDevitt might be Michaela Ruth. She's a girl that was out all last year because of an ACL. She got back into AAU this summer. She's coming back now and I think gaining confidence every single game.
Well, you said she could hit the 12-footer, and we'll take a look at that because I think she'll be tested, and they may need her.
It's the first of two tonight here on High School Sports Live TV. The girls started out, and if you root for the Crusaders, yeah, you're going to win tonight. It's all coming up just in a moment here on High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27.
Hey, guys, just in time.
When Julie wanted to provide some stability for her two boys, she reached out to the Pennsylvania Housing Finance Agency for her home loan. We're proud we could help Julie and her family. If you're looking for an affordable home loan or refinancing option, give us a call. We offer down payment and closing cost assistance too. Call us weekdays 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. or check our website. We're the Pennsylvania Housing Finance Agency. We help homeownership dreams come true.
And welcome back to Lancaster Catholic High School here on Juliet Avenue in beautiful Lancaster, Pennsylvania, where it's a battle of the Crusaders tonight. In blue and gold will be Bishop McDevitt on your left, on the right side in gold and purple and white, Lancaster Catholic. And we are underway, and controlling the tap right out of the gate is Lancaster Catholic. Gary Sutton, Jeff Thompson with you here courtside tonight to bring you the first of two here in a doubleheader. Right out of the gate, and a tight man-to-man there, Jeff.
Coach Bressy's doing what he does best, playing some defense. Let's see if he can protect that basket.
Lancaster Catholic, coached by Charlie Detz, Bishop McDevitt by Joe Bressy. The move to the basket, not going to go from Lauren Mills, and then there's a jump ball with Michaela Ruth, and the ball goes over to Bishop McDevitt, and here comes the press from Lancaster
Catholic. 1-2-1-1, full court.
It's a trapping press right away, and Bishop McDevitt looking to break it, obviously. Nice hard drive to the basket. Not going to go. Lauren Purcell had that, and then quickly back on the other end, and that's what Lancaster Catholic does to you. As Hannah Knowlton in for her first deuce of the night.
That was quick. That was a quick transition.
Rachel Corrigan has it taken away. Again, they come right at you so hard. Ball put up there by Erin Holt, not going to go.
Gary, you said they played four games already this week. They're out running already.
Yeah, this is the fourth game of the week, actually. They played three already. They had crossover week here in the Lancaster Lebanon League, where Section 4 plays Section 3, and second straight turnover now from Bishop McDevitt. Two so far from Bishop McDevitt.
They're handling the press, but they're turning it over at their offensive end, so the press does work.
Aaron Holt handling the basketball. I said Aaron Holt seems like she's been around here forever. There's always been a Holt here somewhere.
And she's ready to tee it up. She can't wait to shoot.
And the ball gets thrown inside to Hannah Knowlton. The foul will get marked up on Amber Corrado. That'll be her first, team first. And they come again. Hard drive to the basket, not going to go. Ruth brings it down. Trapping at half court as well. Everywhere you look, there's a trap right now, and it's paying off as Lancaster Catholic gets it back, and they are on the run. Lane and Nicholas goes hard to the basket, gets it blocked in a lane, dive to the floor. Ball will stay with Lancaster Catholic.
I like the way Michaela Ruth's getting after the ball right now.
Had a chance to coach Michaela Ruth on Team Pennsylvania this summer. I'll tell you what an outstanding kid. I mean, just puts her heart out there every single game. Worked hard to come back from an ACL tear a year ago. Inside, the shot goes up off the hands of Lauren Miles, but she will not make it. And the ball is tipped out of bounds by Lancaster Catholic. Goes back to Bishop McDevitt.
What I've noticed is McDevitt setting up a really nice rebounding triangle out of their man-to-man.
Another turnover, a block down underneath, a nice block underneath by Lauren Mills. But that'll be the fourth turnover here very early in the basketball game.
Yeah, they've been answering, they've been understanding the press, but they turn it over in their front court.
And they're heading back inside. Good job of double teaming down inside by Bishop McDevitt. And turnover for Lancaster Catholic. That's their first of the game. Lauren Purcell, good hard move to the basket, and she's going to draw the foul.
I can see why she's their leading scorer. She takes it to the basket.
Foul's going to be on number four, Annalise Schreider, who's just into the game. Schrader, rather. Now they're going to say no. Put it on Hannah Knowlton instead. Could have taken your pick there. She split both of them. So first shot is up and good from Lauren Purcell. She's averaging 13 points a game, the leading scorer on Bishop McDevitt.
She's been very consistent this year also.
And the second one is up and good. Two for two for Anna Purcell. And we're not at a two right now as they come back with their own press to Bishop McDevitt. Good rebound inside by Annalise Schrader, but not going to go. And Bishop McDevitt on the run. They'll pull it back out.
Going against straight man-to-man.
Running a little 1-4 flat, kind of, and then a potential shooter off two screens. Rachel Corrigan off the double screen up top. Misses a shot. Had a good look at it. She'll knock that down most times. There goes Rachel to the basket. Nice job on defense by Aaron Holt. And you get a walk call against Lancaster Catholic, so they give it back after the defensive play. It'll stay with Bishop McDevitt. Four turnovers so far for the Bishop McDevitt Crusaders and two for Lancaster Catholic. The early going of the girls game here on High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27. 2-2 were knotted up. And another turnover. And quickly answer the bell on the other end is Annalise Schrader. She gets two off the turnover. So far, 4 points off five turnovers here for Lancaster Catholic. Long look outside, not going to go from Amber Corrado. And a foul is going to be called. Foul called on Annalise Schrader. That's her first. Team second against Lancaster Catholic. The ball be inbounded.
Nice set piece.
On a good look inside. They say it's going to be tipped off Lancaster Catholic. Must have been a tip there we didn't see, but we'll stay with Bishop McDevitt. Kayla Ruth, good long look from top of the key and just off the front of the iron.
It just missed.
Lancaster Catholic. Double team down there, and it's going to go back over to Bishop McDevitt. So count that as a turnover against Lancaster Catholic. They've got three in the game. So both teams having a tough time here getting into any kind of rhythm early, Jeff.
Yeah, I noticed that, and I think McDevitt's doing a really fine job in the half-court defense. If they can handle this pressure.
A chance to beat it right here. There it is, Michaela Ruth. Michaela Ruth, wide open look, in and out. Ruth follows her shot, gets it tied up. And we got a jump ball again. We've had five of those so far. And this jump ball will go back over to Lancaster Catholic.
Did you see the way Michaela got through that, got to that offensive board?
Elena Nicholas back into the game now for the Lancaster Catholic version of the Crusaders. And another turnover here as both teams are trapping. And it's really paying dividends. Five turnovers thus far for Bishop McDevitt. Four for Lancaster Catholic.
Similar styles. A 1-2-1-1 zone press for Lancaster Catholic and a 1-2-2 for Bishop McDevitt.
Pull up for the score. There we go. Does not get the bounce. Rebound for Hannah Nolton. Kind of an interesting look there from Nolton. And running one-hander, not going to go. Finally, a stick back. Nice job by Annalise Schroeder. She's the leading scorer of the game now with 4 points. 6-2, Lancaster Catholic leads. Here's McDevitt, has 3-on-2 here.
Nice dish.
Just losing control for a moment was Amber Corrado, and it cost her. Couldn't use the backboard, so Lancaster Catholic with the rebound.
Gary, I like to see him finish off the glass, don't you?
I always like to see, always say the glass is your friend. Whenever you get a chance to use it. Good long look from the outside by Aaron Holt.
And she's their sniper.
Yanked down by Bresky. Oh, and there's a push from behind on the run back. Elena Nicholas is going to pick up her first foul. It'll be the team third against Lancaster Catholic. Got some interesting outfits here tonight over in the first row. It must be pajama night here. We've got a girl with pajamas on, also has the sleeping mask. There you can see him over the top right-hand side of your screen. Hope that's no expression of how they feel about our calling of the game. Bishop McDevitt. Mitchell Corrigan. Again, just missing the shots, and they've got them online, but not going. And Lancaster Catholic running every single time. Lauren Mills, corner, long look. Elena Nicholas won't go. And then the throwaway from Bishop McDevitt, number six in the first quarter. We've got 2:16 to go here in the first quarter. 6-2, Lancaster Catholic leads, and you're watching it all on High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27. Out of the game goes Rachel Corrigan, and in comes Essence Chisholm, a veteran from last year. Tell Joe Bressy really teaching these kids some serious basketball. Now it's thrown off the hands for Lancaster Catholic. So both teams a little sloppy here in quarter number one.
Yeah, neither one has found their rhythm. And I agree with you about Joe. He's a real good teaching the man. Real does a fine job teaching that man-to-man.
Joe Bressy, who Bishop McDevitt, the state championships years ago.
He's had a fine career.
Went to Bloomsburg University.
He told me this afternoon that he was just inducted into Pennsylvania Sports Hall of Fame.
And he certainly deserves it. Great guy, great basketball guy, good person. Bishop McDevitt trying to find a little rhythm here. And the pass just made too late. Turnover number seven here in quarter number one. Going to be controlled and in. That's a 6 point off turnovers as up goes Annalise Schrader. She's been the beneficiary, 6 points. And then quickly on the other end, the answer from Amber Corrado.
That's a beautiful dish by Lauren.
And then the throwaway by Lancaster Catholic. So lots of excitement, unfortunately, with mistakes as Noel Cameron is into the game now for Bishop McDevitt.
Lancaster Catholic changed their alignment on their pressure game. Now going 2-2-1 now, which is more of a containment press.
Caroline Henry in for Lancaster Catholic for the first time. She's a 5'10 senior. Long look downtown, not going to go. Chased down by Ruth. She saves it. Michaela Ruth from the corner. Good look. Michaela Ruth buries it for a three, and Ruth knocks it down here.
Isn't that justice? She ran after that ball, got it back in play, and ended up hitting the tray.
Good rewards come to those who hustle, right? 8-7 right now. Lead been cut to one here for Lancaster Catholic. Henley Schrader wide open underneath. They didn't see her. And it's lost out of bounds again. It's turnover number 7 for the Lancaster Catholic Crusaders. So each team has 7 turnovers so far. Six points off the turnovers of Bishop McDevitt. 3 off the turnovers for Lancaster Catholic.
Well, if they keep this pace up, they'll both have 30 turnovers.
Tell you, I think what you might be seeing too is the effect of having a lot of basketball games this week. I think it's the 3rd for Bishop McDevitt. It's the 4th for Lancaster Catholic. Ball handed out front by Purcell. Chisholm. Corrigan back in there. Corrigan, good look. She doesn't miss that often. There it is. Corrigan buries it. Rachel Corrigan with a 3 from the top of the key. Best look at the house. It's 10-8.
Looks like
Bishop McDevitt on top.
Looks like she has some serious range on her shot, too.
She does. She can really nail it.
There are a couple of male Corrigans who played at McDevitt who could really shoot the ball.
Long look, not going to go, and that's the end of the first quarter. 10-8, Bishop McDevitt leads. We'll take a break. We'll be right back on High School Sports Live TV at ABC 27.
It's always better when you get to pick your team. That's why I didn't just accept the regional health plan offered at work. I went to a Highmark Direct store and picked a more affordable plan with a broader network, one that I feel better with.
For the most value, you're better with Blue. We're reinventing affordable health care for today and for generations to come. For all you do, you're better with Highmark Blue Shield.
Register now.
This year, Advanced Hoops is offering 3 levels of AAU basketball: Silver, Gold, and Team Pennsylvania National Showcase. Fit the 12th grade, join a championship level program. Register now, advancedhoops.com.
Okay, let's see what you got.
Living Well with a Disability is a free source for anyone with any type of disability. We provide countless resources and endless opportunities to live your best.
I really am living well.
Call 1-877-2-LIVE-WELL to discover resources available for you.
And welcome back to Lancaster Catholic High School, where the lead belongs to the Crusaders at the end of the first quarter, but the Bishop McDevitt version, the Lancaster Catholic Crusaders down. That's 10-8 as we start quarter number 2.
And that last 3 was by Rachel Corrigan. She had a couple siblings that played basketball at Shippensburg University.
Good hard drive to the basket. Again by Corrigan, rebound by Bishop McDevitt. They've been hot on the board. Ball yanked out of there by Caroline Henry and then stolen away by Essence Chisholm. Are they going to hang on to it? And it's out of bounds on Lancaster Catholic. So they get the turnover. First of the second quarter, 8 to the game.
Was that Essence? She slid about 20 feet.
She ran hard with that to get the basketball. So back it goes to Purcell in the backcourt. Purcell very good handling the basketball. Corrigan again, wide open look. Corrigan knocks it down. Rachel Corrigan with her 6th point of the game, both via the 3.
C-O-double-R-I.
She is launching right here, and it's 13-8. Bishop McDevitt leads. And the ball goes back for it. Another turnover. One of the things you got to think tonight, Caroline Scarf is the leading scorer for Lancaster Catholic. She averages 15.2 points a game. And she's one of their inside presences. And Caroline Scarf is out tonight. The junior has the flu. She averages, as you said, 15 points a game. So certainly they're missing that tonight as far as a stabilizer there. A junior at 5 feet, 11 inches. So she's a big one.
That's a big loss for them. That may be why they're a little out of kilter to this point.
3 threes in the game so far out of the 13 points. So 9 of them have come from behind the arc. Corrigan open for just a second there.
I thought she was going to let it fly, didn't you?
It's just a moment of time. Passed inside, reached to Michaela Ruth. Michaela Ruth with a nice left hand has 5 points in the game and 7 point lead now for Bishop McDevitt. Missed on the other end by Knowlton. Bishop McDevitt rebounds and they're coming the other way.
Beautiful pass by Lauren Purcell. And better finish.
Purcell, good hard drive to the basket. Rebounded again. I tell you, Bishop McDevitt is hot on the offensive boards, but the foul will be called this time on Lauren Purcell. That'll be her first, team's second against Bishop McDevitt.
I would say that McDevitt's doing yeoman's work on the board, if you could say that about a girls' game.
Well, at least yo woman's work on the board, then. Maybe we could invent a word. I don't know, but I'd agree with you. Sarah LeMaster into the game for Bishop McDevitt.
And McDevitt staying with the pressure game.
Karina Rivera getting trapped over the side. She just did the game. Now there's Knowlton, finally gets to her, trap everywhere, and then a good find on the weak side. And in for the two is Julia Bright, her first points of the night. Good job breaking the press by Lancaster Catholic. And tipped out of bounds by Knowlton, who is really hustling everywhere. 15-10. Bishop McDevitt leads by five with 2 minutes to go until halftime. Checking into the game now is Isabel Miller, a sophomore guard, wearing number 11. See a lot of players being rotated by Coach Charlie Detz. Corrigan gets a look in the quarter again. Corrigan having a hot hand, just misses off the back of the iron. Rebounded again by who else? Knowlton.
Quick release by Corrigan.
There's Aaron Holt. Good hard drive to the basket, but it's not going to go from Karina Rivera.
Michaela's owning the glass right now.
Here comes Brianna Bresky. Wide open look for Michaela. Not going to take it. Back to Corrigan. Back to Michaela Ruth. Noelle Cameron in there now, wearing number 11. One look from LeMaster, and going to get a foul called.
They're running the flex, and they threw a screen out that he called a foul on.
Noelle Cameron threw the screen. It was an illegal one, so she picks up her first. It'll be the team third.
They're doing a nice job with their offense, though. I like that flex, the way they're running it.
They're getting some really good looks, again, from the three-point territory. To make those, you're in business. Another turnover against Lancaster Catholic, third of this quarter.
Michaela Ruth, the recipient of that turnover.
Corrigan off the front of the iron that time. And taken down by Hannah Knowlton.
She's got the quick trigger, and it's a good one. That's what
I was look by Aaron Holt, in and out. Holt had a good look that time and just could not get it to go down. Then she steals it back. Throws it back up there. Is it going to go? Shooter's roll. Yeah, it goes. Aaron Holt for two.
That was fortuitous, that bounce.
Yeah. Put the emphasis on the two there. Oh, off the legs of Bishop McDevitt. That's her second turnover now this quarter. Ninth of the game.
These aren't unforced turnovers. There's a lot of trapping going on out there. I can hear Coach Bressy saying, close the trap, close the trap.
8 points off turnovers so far for Lancaster Catholic. They've only scored 12. So 15-12 right now.
Gary, you think they're getting bothered by this pressure?
Need to correct what we have on the board there. It's 15-12, actually. Bishop McDevitt beating Lancaster Catholic now.
Good recovery in the corner.
Really focused to the inside, trying to get the Lauren Mills. Reverse it far side. Long look. Not going to go. Rebound yanked down by Essence Chisholm.
Nice checkout by Essence Chisholm.
And Michaela Ruth. Long look. Bothered right at the end. Misses the shot. It's 15-12 right now. 3:53 to go in the first half. We'll take a timeout on High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27.
The Advanced Hoops basketball program has professional skill training. Advanced Hoops is unique as we offer professional point guard and dribbling with Gerald Jarman.
As a former point guard at the University of Richmond, I led one of the greatest upsets ever against Syracuse in 1991. I get more fulfillment out of teaching young athletes the things that I learned and the keys that I learned both in college and professionally.
Charlie Fortney's shooting instruction is amazing. He's helped many high-level players get a great shooting foundation for the college level.
You already know your Giant bonus card is a great way to bag real savings on groceries. But it does so much more, like helping you pump up your fuel discount with gas extra rewards. Just by using your Giant bonus card, you'll save 10 cents per gallon for every $100 you spend. So the more you buy, the more you save. Gas extra rewards, fueled by Giant.
And coming up at halftime, it will be the Ambassador Advisors Halftime Report. Jeff Reinhardt from Penn Live is going to be stopping up here. We're looking forward to talking to him tonight. I don't think he ever sleeps. He's just on stats and teams all the time. The guy's a fanatic about basketball, girls basketball. He'll be with us at halftime. We'll also give you the Highmark halftime stats as well. Lancaster Catholic breaking the press here.
And zoom through at that time.
And the look off the hands of Lauren Mills. No good, but she's going to go to the line here for two. And the foul on Rachel Corrigan. That's her first, team fourth of the first half. 15-12. Bishop McDevitt leads Lancaster Catholic. And at the line is Lauren Miles. First time Lancaster Catholic's been at the line tonight. And they got a good one. I said Lawrence Miles. Forgive me, Lawrence Mills.
She went to the hole very strong with her right hand. After they effectively broke that pressure.
Mills' second one is up and good. So Lauren Mills converts both. She's got two. Pulls her team back within one here. Bishop McDevitt leads by one with 3:38 to go in the first half. Great job by Purcell, beating the pressure.
Interesting, they went straight man-to-man pressure that time, did Lancaster Catholic.
Purcell being guarded hard there by Isabel Miller into the game. Another look, not going to go. That's from... Amber Corrado, who got a pretty good look. The ball belongs to Lancaster Catholic.
Good tussle inside between Schrader and Essence.
Hard man-to-man pressure now by Bishop McDevitt.
With a trap at the end.
Holt wide open. She's a good three-point shooter. She buries it.
That's what we were waiting for.
You knew she was going to get one sooner or later. She's got 5 points now. First one from the arc this evening. Get a foul in the backcourt. Noella Cameron. Noella is going to pick up her second foul in the backcourt. It'll be the team fifth.
Aaron plays really hard. We were waiting for that three the whole first half.
Well, they found her on the weak side. The other one, she really didn't get a good look. That time she had plenty of time, locked it in, and took it home. 17-15, Lancaster Catholic back on top. Under 3 minutes to play in the first half. Essence Chisholm, long look, not going to go. Rebounded. Julia Bright is running with it. And Bright takes it hard to the basket. And Cameron, if it's on her, that will be foul number three. And check that, it will not be. It will be on Essence Chisholm. So Essence Chisholm gets called for the foul.
When Lancaster Catholic gets the defensive rebound, they're off to the races.
Yeah, they like to put the ball to the floor, and they'll always take it at you hard. Back inside it goes. Half hook shot, not going to go from Lauren Mills. And it goes out of bounds off the Lancaster Catholic Crusaders, so Bishop McDevitt gets it back. They're down by two.
The referees are talking about that call.
Tom Strickler walks over and says, did I get it right? Yeah, Bishop McDevitt still has it.
Wow, the center fielder, face guard, the two guards.
Coming at it hard now is Lauren Purcell. Pull it back out now, set up the offense.
Good solid screens by McDevitt on this flex offense.
Basically the flex offense, side to side. And no call there. And Michaela Ruth wondering how she got the ball and saw two white shirts there underneath. But the ball remains with Bishop McDevitt as they run 1-4 flat on the line. We'll get some kind of lob here. And it's inbounds to Michaela Ruth. Good. pull up, jump stop. Not going to go for Brianna Bresky. And then quickly the other end.
Wow, they look long right away, too.
Hannah Knowlton released as soon as the shot went up, and Hannah Knowlton puts it up. Not going to go. Taken away again by Annalise Schrader, and Schrader called for the offensive foul.
Annalise was very aggressive that possession. She got the ball back aggressively and took it to the hole. Unfortunately, they called a charge.
Annalise Schrader, that'll be her second foul.
She's done a real fine job. She did not start the game.
Both teams with five team fouls thus far. 1:42 to go in the first half. 17-15, Lancaster Catholic leads. Both teams have settled down here with the ball handling in the second quarter, too. They're not making as many shots. When you don't make as many shots, you don't get a chance to set up your presses like we saw in the first quarter.
Nice catch. Pass and catch, pass and catch.
Good job of handling the basketball here. Pull up. Not going to go off the hands of Purcell. Ball out of bounds off Bishop McDevitt. Into the game for Lancaster Catholic comes Landon Nicholas and replacing Annalise Schrader. Here you see Charlie Detz. What's interesting is Lamar Coffin, who coached here for such a long time, was so successful, had two state championships. Good pass down there, and Knowlton's going to score. Cannon Knowlton with her fourth point of the night. But Charlie Detz, also a Columbia boy. He played at Columbia and then played for Glenn Robinson at F&M. And up goes Ruth. She's hit again on the play, and the foul is going to be nailed instead on Noelle Cameron, and if that's her foul, it should be the third.
So he's in your coaching lineage, isn't he?
Well, he came to my camp when he was like a 7th and 8th grader, and he was about 5'1". He's now 6'9", and had a great career at F&M with Glenn Robinson, who is just the winningest Division III coach in the country right here in Lancaster, coaching at F&M, one of the great coaches of all time. So
Glenn doesn't like to lose, does he?
Never likes to lose. In fact, his son's name is Wynn. Give you any idea? I play golf with Glenn a lot during the summer, and I'll tell you, just a great guy to be around and truly one of the best coaches in the United States. And by the way, I think I see Mari Coffin over on the far side there. We get a shot over in the far right corner. Mari Coffin there. We'll take a break. We'll come back on High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27.
No regrets.
If only she parked in a garage. If only they had the chimney cleaned. If only they had Erie Insurance. Erie is seriously good insurance that treats you fairly and goes above and beyond to make you feel like your auto or home mishap never happened. At rates that'll save you as much as the other guys. So get a quote from Erie today. Because whatever your regrets in life, your insurance company shouldn't be one of them.
Welcome back to High School Sports Live TV. It's 19-15. The Lancaster Catholic leads 25.4 seconds to go in the half. Just saw Lamar Coffin, the former coach here, in the gym for a moment. He walked back out the door, but I'm sure he'll be back in later.
Legendary coach. Aaron's three has spelled the difference in this half.
Ticking down now to 10 seconds. Aaron Holt stuck out there, picks it up. 5 seconds. Are they going to get off a shot? Here it goes. Nice little layup out of it. Put away by Julia Bright, and that's it. Halftime. 21-15 is the lead for Lancaster Catholic. We'll be back with your halftime report, sponsored tonight by Ambassador Advisors, and your Highmark halftime stats as well. And an interview with Jeff Reinhardt of Penn Live, all here on the High School Sports Live TV presentation of basketball on ABC 27.
The Advanced Hoops basketball program has professional skill training. Advanced Hoops is unique as we offer professional point guard and dribbling with Gerald Jarman.
As a former point guard at the University of Richmond, I led one of the greatest upsets ever against Syracuse in 1991. I get more fulfillment out of teaching young athletes the things that I learned and the keys that I learned both in college and professionally.
Charlie Fortney's shooting instruction is amazing. He's helped many high-level players get a great shooting foundation for the college level.
You already know your Giant bonus card is a great way to bag real savings on groceries. But it does so much more, like helping you pump up your fuel discount with gas extra rewards. Just by using your Giant bonus card, you'll save 10 cents per gallon for every $100 you spend. So the more you buy, the more you save. Gas Extra Rewards, fueled by Giant.
Hey guys, just in time.
When Julie wanted to provide some stability for her two boys, she reached out to the Pennsylvania Housing Finance Agency for her home loan. We're proud we could help Julie and her family. If you're looking for an affordable home loan or refinancing option, give us a call. We offer down payment and closing cost assistance too. Call us weekdays 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. or check our website. We're the Pennsylvania Housing Finance Agency. We help home ownership dreams come true.
From Times Square to your local community, from local sports to international conventions, Invica has changed the broadcast and video landscape, bringing professional quality and service to organizations across the globe. Through professional, college-level, and local sports, festivals, competitions, parades, and telethons, conferences, and commercials, Invica is bringing the power of video to more people and markets than ever before. Have a project you need covered? Check out our website for more information. Invica, providing affordable HD video solutions.
Welcome back to Lancaster Catholic High School, where Lancaster Catholic leads here at the half, 21-15. And you're watching it all here on High School Sports Live 3 at ABC 27. But up here at halftime is Jeff Reinhardt, who I always kid, never sleeps.
You're right.
Constantly doing stats, knows what every team is doing around here, especially girls basketball. And you're kind of the guru out there. Jeff, always good
nice
to have
to see
you up
here. Thank you, sir.
First half seemed kind of weird for me sitting here watching a half of basketball play to Lancaster Catholic without Lamar Kaufman. Mario Kaufman, as he's known, sitting on the bench.
Yeah.
But he is in the house tonight. But
you
got a Columbia boy in there, Charlie Dutch. So that's kind of an interesting lineage there, kind of moving on.
Yeah. Transition's been great. And he's coached boys' teams around here. He was at Penn Manor and Columbia.
Right.
And kids love him. Not a whole lot of changes, stuck with the presses. You'll hear a lot of the same kind of verbiage, 51, 52. He added a little bit of his own style, but they're still doing a lot of the same things that Lamar did here, and I'm sure that was in the interview. You know, hey, what are you going to do? Are you going to blow it up? Are you going to start again? Are you going to keep the presses? And the kids here, they press and trap and run, and that's what they do, and he's kept it.
Done a nice job of it tonight. Bush McDevitt hanging in there pretty well, though, looking pretty good so far.
Yeah, they're a little cold. They haven't scored in a while. They've been stuck on 15 for a bit.
Got that 15-13 lead, and then went scoreless there at the end of the half.
Yeah, and what's that saying? Teams that press and trap don't like to be pressed and trapped.
I always hear that, and I've never really tested that out and looked at it totally, but I've heard that all the time. It's one of those things you say, and you go, "Is that really true? I'm not sure." But you know, someone said it for a reason. This is also a week where I know Lancaster Catholic has gone through a week. They won by a total of 5 points in the previous three games. Two of them in overtime.
Yes.
Fourth game of the week.
Yes.
And on the other side for Bishop McDevitt, third game of the week. So it's a long week for these teams, too. I know a lot of teams are out playing tonight. This is the time of year where they want to play that second game.
Yeah, big time. Lancaster Catholic clinched the Section 4 championship last night, by
Hard
the way.
To believe.
On January 16th, they're already the section champs. So go ahead and they could put a banner up next week already. I saw two of the games. I saw the Calico game in OT on Monday, which was phenomenal. Aaron Holt with a big three late to tie it. I was at the game Wednesday at Northern Lebanon. Overtime, Catholic was down 15 in the first half, hung in. They're playing pretty good here tonight without Caroline Scarf, who is
averaging
ill.
15 points a game.
She's their big girl underneath. Yeah. She's having a super junior season. She's closing in on 1,000 points this season. She's been great. I think they're hanging tough without her here.
Yeah, doing a great job. Talk about districts. You know, a lot of people are looking ahead now to districts, and it's an interesting group. A lot of Lancaster Lebanon teams around.
Yes.
A lot of mid-Penn teams around. Who are you looking at right now in this particular division especially?
Okay. The team that fascinates me more than anybody is Central Dauphin East.
Right. Seen them play twice.
Undefeated. Beat Cumberland Valley, fair and square. They've been great, and they have CB coming up in a couple of weeks. I think that's
a TV
game, by the way. There's your plug.
Night.
That'll be phenomenal. Yep. I will be over there for that. That'll be a great game. They're fascinating. No losses. I have them sixth in the state because it's quad A and it's tough to crash, and I know they beat CB. I still have CB number one in the state.
Yeah.
They only have the one loss. They're the defending champs with four kids back and a Villanova commit and Kelly Jacott, who's a wonderful player. CD East, really just love them. Triple A,
right.
Wide open. West Perry's the champ. They've been great. 14-2, lost to Trinity last night. Triple A's wide open. No Palmyra. They're in quad, which adds to the quad A intrigue, I think, big time.
And they're having a great season.
Yes, they are.
Finally got beat the other night by Mechanicsburg.
Mechanicsburg's another quad A team you must watch out for. They only have the one loss. They'll play in the 40s. Not pretty.
They jumped
but they're
this McDevitt team pretty hard last night.
40-19.
Yeah.
You can't score against them. They are really good.
Cecily,
really like mechanics.
Cecily Carl having a great senior season.
She's phenomenal. American University recruit, 1,000-point kid, solid. Really like Mechanicsburg again. No frills, but they're a dynamite solid team.
And the last two, Double A, who are you looking at right now?
Double A will be phenomenal. York Catholic, DeLone.
Have we ever heard those names before? I don't know.
Those two, Camp Hill and Trinity.
There you go.
Wow.
Pretty good stuff.
That should be an unbelievable Final Four in Double A. Can't wait.
Saw Trinity and Camp Hill hook up on High School Sports Live TV the other week. I think it was an overtime game, if memory serves, or close.
I think you're correct.
Yeah.
Double A will be great. I know it's the usual suspects. But it's still fun to watch them play and watch DeLone play York Catholic for the 890th time.
Yeah.
But that Double A is going to be great. That Final Four should be awesome.
Jeff, always great having you up here on the deck. Now,
absolutely.
Final thought, Single
yes.
A.
Single A. Harrisburg Christian's the defending champ. They would still be the one seed. Christian School of York. Remember them?
They're playing well.
Halifax, I think they're going to be your pick. They have 3 or 4 losses, but they lost last year in the final to Steele High, which is up in Double this year. So, as of January 17th, I'll go Halifax. I think they're your team to beat right now.
Read Jeff Reinhardt on Penn Live. He's there every night. He's got all the numbers for the next day. So you want to find out tonight, very quickly, early tomorrow, what happened? He's the guy.
Thank you, Jeff Reinhardt,
here at Halftime on High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27. We'll be right back with your Halftime Stats.
Karen has 459 friends. But none of them made sure she got home okay. None of them suggested she skip the next drink, try a glass of water, or maybe just call it a night. Karen has 459 friends. But tonight, what she really needed was one good one.
The Advanced Hoops basketball program has professional skill training. Advanced Hoops is unique as we offer professional point guard and dribbling with Gerald Jarman.
As a former point guard at the University of Richmond, I led one of the greatest upsets ever against Syracuse in 1991. I get more fulfillment out of teaching young athletes the things that I learned and the keys that I learned both in college and professionally.
Charlie Fortney's shooting instruction is amazing. He's helped many high-level players get a great shooting foundation for the college level.
There's a place where kids really connect to learning. Commonwealth Connections Academy. It's a tuition-free, fully accredited online public school where students find devoted, enthusiastic teachers like never before. Commonwealth Connections Academy, the online public school.
From Times Square to your local community, from local sports to international conventions, Invica has changed the broadcast and video landscape, bringing professional quality and service to organizations across the globe. Through professional, college level, and local sports, festivals, competitions, parades, and telethons, conferences, and commercials, Invica is bringing the power of video to more people and markets than ever before. Have a project you need covered? Check out our website for more information. Invica, providing affordable HD video solutions.
Register now.
This year, Advanced Hoops is offering 3 levels of AAU basketball: silver, gold, and Team Pennsylvania National Showcase. Fifth to 12th grade, join a championship level program. Register now, advancedhoops.com.
Welcome back to our Ambassador Advisors Halftime Report, and it's time to take a look at the Highmark Halftime Stats. And there you see it, 6-point lead. 3-pointers so far has really kept Bishop McDevitt in the game. They've made 3, one on the other side for Lancaster Catholic. Both teams doing well from the free throw line. Turnovers 10-9. It's close there. It's close in rebounds. The one difference so far, I think, has been the points in transition that you've seen from Lancaster Catholic off mistakes. They've got 8 points right now off 9 Bishop McDevitt turnovers. On the other side, Bishop McDevitt's only been able to turn in 3 points off 10 Lancaster Catholic turnover. So I think the points in transition have really been a difference so far, Jeff.
They're very similar teams, and I agree that the one thing that Lancaster Catholic has that McDevitt doesn't is they finish plays and they look to go long all the time.
So we'll get ready to start the second half. Bishop McDevitt will have the basketball inbounded by Purcell, and she'll find Brianna Bresky, and we are underway in the second half. 21-15, Lancaster Catholic leads. Battle of Crusaders tonight. This is the first of two. The boys coming up next. Rachel Corrigan with a running one-hander, not going to go. Kind of lost control there for a moment. Scramble on the floor, get it back outside. Another look has not been able to go tonight so far for Amber Corrado. The ball tipped out of bounds. Corrado kind of hits the wall and says, one of these is going to go down soon.
Hey, I'm watching Julia Bright play defense on Hannah Purcell. It's pretty impressive.
Back in to Michaela Ruth.
Looks like they're matching up. They're switching automatically out front, so it's some kind of matchup zone.
Another throw up there, not going to go. Off the hands of Corrado. Here comes Aaron Holt. Lots of pressure in the backcourt from Brianna Bresky.
But she's up to the task once again.
Long look to the outside, and there's Holt, who's getting unlocked now. It's her second three of the night. She's got 8 points.
She's kind of taken over the last few minutes of the game.
Stretched it out to a 9-point lead, largest lead of the night so far for Lancaster Catholic. Bishop McDevitt has not scored in a long time from the end of the first half, but the last 3 minutes. Finally, Michaela Ruth gets it on the side. Can't go. Diving on the floor after it is Corrado. Keeping it alive. There's Lauren Mills. We've got a jump ball on the floor between Lauren Mills and Lauren Purcell, and it's going to go Lancaster Catholic's way.
Both teams are getting after the ball.
There you see the hustle. Lauren Mills and Corrado diving to the floor to get it.
McDevitt has to make something happen with their pressure game.
Coming back with that trap now. Not been able to trap for a while because they haven't been able to make buckets. You can't get a pressure point there if you can't make the basket. Aaron Holt, double team. And the ball goes inside to Hannah Knowlton, who walks with it. So first turnover of this quarter. Make it the 11th turnover of the game. And then right back on the other side. Turnover is a fair play, or is that turnabout?
It's close, though. Lauren Mills is doing a nice job.
Aaron Holt open again. Inside, offensive rebound, and the stick back attempt not going to go from Elena Nicholas, but she'll get fouled on the play and will go to the line for two. Foul marked up on Rachel Corrigan, her second. Team first in the second half. A 9-point lead they have carved out as Lancaster Catholic will take a timeout. 24-15, Lancaster Catholic leads on High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27.
No matter the season, when it's time to gear up, you've got to get to Kelly's Sports. Kelly's Sports. Top quality sports equipment for the field, the rink, the court, and more. Matched with the experience and knowledge to help you get the winning edge. Plus all the latest styles from Nike, Adidas, and Under Armour. And a large selection of name brand athletic footwear. Local sports team members get 10% off all purchases. Kelly's Sports. In the High Point Commons, Harrisburg. Or visit online at kellysports.com.
And there you see Charlie Detz working with his troops right now. Charlie gets down the ground on his knees, and he's still as tall as anybody in the huddle. Down on the other end, Joe Bressy trying to figure out a way to get his team to score in the half-court game.
I noticed down there next to Joe, if you want to take a look, Dave Kestner was his assistant back in the 80s when Joe had his run at McDevitt, and they're back together again.
Kestner used to be a head coach over at Susquehanna for a while. And that lineage, we'll talk about in the second game, too, because there's another lineage there to Susquehanna as well. Joe Kestner, a great guy. Went to one of his camps and spoke one year. Just a really good person. The first one is up and good for Elena Nicholas. First points for her tonight. Nicholas' second one is up and good. An 11-point lead now forged by Lancaster Catholic. And then Nicholas gets called for, you might say, one of those sloppy fouls in the back where you never want to see. That's her second.
Well, she's being aggressive, and you can't fault one of your athletes for aggressiveness. I think that's what you want them to be.
Yeah, but bumping in 70 feet from the basket, not really having a chance even to get the ball. Put it this way, she'd be having a chat with me. With a hard drive to the basket, and finally good. Lauren Purcell gets a Clara Barton bucket there. Stop the bleeding, come on. And Purcell gets it in and off the glass.
She looked a lot like Gabby from last night, that look away, if you take a look at her drive.
Gabby Blackburn, we're talking about. for Hershey. And then Purcell finishes it off. Purcell now with 5 points in the game, 3 out of 3 from the line. And Bishop McDevitt going with kind of a soft trap here. Lancaster Catholic still up by 8, 26 to 18.
Lauren Mills is handling the pressure very well. She's got a little bit more size and can see over that those traps.
Bishop McDevitt kind of plays kind of a contained kind of defense here. Don't really put a lot of pressure anywhere but the ball. There's a takeaway. And a good drive to the basket. Once again by Lauren Purcell. That'll be turnover number 12 now against Lancaster Catholic. So Purcell goes back to the line.
She's one Bishop McDevitt player that will go to the basket.
She goes hard. Well, Corrigan will go hard as well, and so will Ruth given the chance. First one is up and good from Purcell. So Purcell with 4 points already in this quarter. Purcell's up. This one's not going to go. So out of the 12 turnovers so far, Bishop McDevitt's only been able to get 4 points off that. So they need to have a, you know, those turnovers, you create new possessions, but then you got to cash them in on the other end.
Yeah, you'd hope you could get some easy buckets out of that.
There's a Catholic getting a little loose with the ball right now. Brett Julia picks it up.
I'd say McDevitt's clawing back.
And they're doing it right now off turnovers again. 13th turnover of the game, third of this quarter. Charlie Dess just took his coat off.
What is he?
Never good
here.
When coaches take the coats off. Corrigan wide open. She's good at out there. Just off the front of the iron. Michaela Ruth battling. Knocked away, though, by an equally hustling Julia Bright. And then good hustle down there on the other end as well by Lauren Purcell to knock away the post pass.
She came out of nowhere.
Holt wide open. Holt long look. Holt good for three. Aaron Holt hooking it up now from downtown. That's her third three of the night. She's got 11.
I think she's owned the last 6 minutes of the basketball game.
Yeah, I think it's a great observation, Jeff. Both defensively and offensively. Corrado. And Corrado finally gets one to go down. Amber Corrado with her second two of the night.
How about that defender biting for that pump fake?
Bishop McDevitt hanging in there, 8 points down. Holt breaks the double team. And then in the backcourt, another foul called. It's Julia Bright handling it. And the foul will be on Brianna Bresky. That should be her first. That'll be the team's second. Let's take a look at Aaron Holt. She has been outstanding tonight. There's 1-3. There's, you know, I kind of like the feel of that. Let's try it again. There's another one. And she says, it felt so good. Let me try that trifecta. Yeah, that worked too. Threes have been the story tonight for Aaron Holt. She's got 11 points. And another one. This one not going to go. Rushed it just a little bit. Jump ball on the baseline. Ball belonged to Bishop McDevitt. I thought your observation about Aaron Holt, though, is absolutely right. She has been the factor that has stepped up here. They know that she's a good outside shooter, but, you know, when outside shooters can set their feet and she's able to set her feet, nothing but that.
Yeah, they tagged her a little bit better the last shot of hers.
With Purcell, the point guard on the other side, handling the pressure. Rachel Corrigan trying to find an opening. She's got it. Long look. Corrigan off the back of the iron, rebounded by Knowlton. So 2:56 to go this quarter. Still an 8-point lead for Lancaster Catholic. And back inside, they've got Lauren Mills. And Lauren Mills, a little fade away, but she'll get fouled on the play. Foul should be against Michaela Ruth. And that'll be Michaela Ruth's first foul. Team fourth of the quarter. So at the line is Lauren Mills. 2 out of 2 there so far tonight. Make it 3 out of 3.
So she brings the ball up and posts up when they get on offense.
Noelle Cameron back into the game now for Amber Corrado.
Yeah, that's a pretty good inside-outside situation. Helps them beat the pressure and then scores inside.
And you're going to get a foul against Bishop McDevitt chasing the ball down.
Julia Bright sold that one.
The foul on Michaela Ruth again. So very quickly, Michaela Ruth gets her first two fouls of the game here.
Watch a shooter. Watch a shooter.
Oh, trying to get her feet there again. Good job by Lauren Purcell on her. Back inside it goes. Hannah Knowlton's going to get fouled. Is this going to be against Michaela Ruth? Nope. This time it goes up against Noelle Cameron. That will be her fourth foul for Cameron. And they're going to say, no, it's only the third.
I also like about Aaron, she's getting that entry pass into the post very effectively.
You know, you look at Charlie Detz over there, the head coach for Lancaster Catholic, and you know where the ball is going to go most of the time. He's 6'9", right? So he's figuring, hey, you know, you got to reward those big people. They'll get kind of sad if you don't feed them sometimes, right?
He's probably not a guard coach at heart. And Warren Goodling, who we'll see in the next game,
is a guard coach. One of the better guards that ever played around the area, too, at West York and then Shippensburg. Paul Luce.
Wow, how about that?
Called three white shirts on the floor at one time and one blue, and the ball remains with Bishop McDevitt.
There was only one Lancaster Crusader that didn't dive on the floor.
Take a look at this. It's called hustle. Good trap. Ball's knocked loose. Get on the floor. Get after it. Show you want it. Right there, you're going to win a coach's heart every time the ball actually... Paul switched and it belongs to Lancaster Catholic. Aaron Holt. Long pass to Knowlton. Knowlton throws it up. Not going to go. Pick it down by Ruth. Double team. And you're going to get a foul called. Take your pick. Four or five. I'm going to say four. And they'll say five. Yeah. Hannah Knowlton called for the foul. It'll be her second.
There was a headhunter pick out of half court. I don't know if the camera caught that from Lancaster Catholic.
14 fouls so far on Lancaster Catholic, 5 on Bishop McDevitt. 30-21, Lancaster Catholic leads by 9.
And Coach Detz is now in a 1-3-1 half-court zone defense.
The drive to the basket again, getting it up there and rolling it down is Lauren Purcell, and she really has taken over this quarter for her team. 6 points in the quarter. Quickly back on the other end. Long jump shot, not going to go off the hands of Lauren Mills. Down to 7 points here, 30-23, Lancaster Catholic leads.
Did you see Lauren, the left-hander, put that one up with her right? Pretty sweet.
Oregon trying to get her feet set. Holt says, that's what I do. She's guarding. Michaela Ruth had a good look out there. Now, you got to swing one more time. You got Corrigan wide open for the three. Corrigan lets it go. Corrigan knocks it down. She was standing over there, itching with the fingers.
That's some good stuff right there.
9 points all via the tray. Rachel Corrigan, the great job, and then a charge on the other end as you see Michaela Ruth holding her ground, and the charge is going to be called against Lancaster Catholic, the player control foul. That'll be on Annalise Schroeder.
Did Michaela take that charge? Because she has two fouls. That was a great move on her part.
Yeah, Michaela hung in there and stood and took it down. So third foul marked up on Annalise Schroeder. Be the 15th foul, so 5 either way. A 4-point lead now. It's dwindled down to the Lancaster Catholic. And Bishop McDevitt with a chance to carve into it even more here. Purcell getting ridden. And another foul called on Lancaster Catholic.
Do you know Lancaster Catholic went out of their 1-3-1 because of that 3-point shot?
So the foul against Lancaster Catholic. And the foul is going to be on... They're going to report that again. I'm not sure he gave the right number. That's what confused me. So the foul will be on Karina Rivera into the game. That's her third foul. Big, big possession here with 51 seconds to go in the third quarter. Corrigan open again. She's hot. Corrigan with her fourth three of the game. Rachel Corrigan buries it. And this one is a one-pointer now. was 9 a moment ago. 9 unanswered points from Bishop McDevitt. 30-29, Lancaster Catholic leads. Holt says, I can answer it, though. Holt, downtown. We got a three fest going on. That's your third three of this quarter.
It's a shootout.
14 points in the game now for Holt. Wow.
Holt and Corrigan are just impressive right now.
Corrigan with four threes. Holt with four threes. 12 seconds to go. Stolen away by Lancaster Catholic. Hannah Knowlton chases it down, puts it up, in. 6 seconds to go as Knowlton puts it away.
Huge turnover.
Long look outside, not gonna go. We head to the fourth, 35-29. Lancaster Catholic leads Bishop McDevitt. This is High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27.
The Advanced Hoops basketball program has professional skill training. Advanced Hoops is unique as we offer professional point guard and dribbling with Gerald Jarman.
As a former point guard at the University of Richmond, I led one of the greatest upsets ever against Syracuse in 1991. I get more fulfillment out of teaching young athletes the things that I learned and the keys that I learned both in college and professionally.
Charlie Fortney's shooting instruction is amazing. He's helped many high-level players get a great shooting foundation for the college level.
It's always better when you get to pick your team. That's why I didn't just accept the regional health plan offered at work. I went to a Highmark Direct store and picked a more affordable plan with a broader network, one that I feel better with.
For the most value, you're better with Blue. We're reinventing affordable health care for today and for generations to come. For all you do, you're better with Highmark Blue Shield.
Hey guys, just in time.
When Julie wanted to provide some stability for her two boys, she reached out to the Pennsylvania Housing Finance Agency for her home loan. We're proud we could help Julie and her family. If you're looking for an affordable home loan or refinancing option, give us a call. We offer down payment and closing cost assistance too. Call us weekdays 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. or check our website. We're the Pennsylvania Housing Finance Agency. We help homeownership dreams come true.
And we start the fourth quarter here at Lancaster Catholic High School, where Lancaster Catholic leads at 35-29. Almost a five-second call. Lauren Purcell bails out. Gets it. Wide open. Knocked down. The first deuce for Rachel Corrigan tonight. Rachel Corrigan now with 14 points in the game and a four-point lead for Lancaster Catholic. 35-31.
Purcell worked very hard to get her that shot.
Erin Holt handling the basketball for Lancaster Catholic. She's had a great game. Long look. Outside. Not going to go. Picked off by Purcell. Purcell and Holt guarded each other. It's a great matchup. Another long look outside. Maybe a little quick that time off the hands of Brianna Bresky. And Lancaster Catholic's got it. And they're on the run. Driving hard to the basket. Elena Nicholas. Not going to go. Bresky. With the ball for McDevitt. 6:46 to go in this one. Don't forget we have a boys game following up tonight. Taylor Ruth has it. She's got a left hand. Long look, not going to go from Purcell. It was kind of like, there's nothing else much going on. And a timeout for Joe Bressy. We'll take one as well. 6:30 to go in this one. 34-31. Lancaster Catholic leads Bishop McDevitt on High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27.
Karen has 459 friends, but none of them made sure she got home okay. None of them suggested she skip the next drink, try a glass of water, or maybe just call it a night. Karen has 459 friends. But tonight, what she really needed was one good one.
And what a night it has been for Rachel Corrigan. She had the ability to shoot the three. Everybody knew it. There's the first one she had of the night. Wide open look, top of the key. But it didn't stop there. Got in the far corner, throws it back out to her. She's there in the same place again. Don't let her get those feet set. Another one. And it's raining down threes from Corrigan here in the gymnasium. She wasn't done yet. She got a fourth one as well. So Corrigan with 14 points tonight. She averages 8 points a game normally for the Crusaders. They're down by four here. Underneath, Michaela Ruth wide open. Michaela Ruth can't quite get it, but she'll go to the line for two.
Great pass by Bresky inside.
Here's a foul marked up against. Wait and see.
Good things happen for Michaela when she's been hustling.
Erin Holt called for the foul. For Erin Holt, that'll be her first, team seventh, as Michaela Ruth cashes in her sixth point of the night. Make it two in a row for Ruth, 7 points. Back to a two-point game. Lancaster Catholic has the basketball. There's some of that pressure in the backcourt. Now you got to worry about 10 seconds. Instead, you got to get a timeout. Charlie Dentz burns it to save the 10-second call. We'll take a break. We'll be right back. High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27.
Register now.
This year, Advanced Hoops is offering three levels of AAU basketball: silver, gold, and Team Pennsylvania National Showcase. Fifth to 12th grade, join a championship-level program. Register now, advancedhoops.com.
We are back, and you're in the huddle of Joe Bressy, who's cheering his team on right now. And both these coaches have done a nice job, I think, of using their timeouts. Joe Bressy used a couple a few minutes ago to one to stop the some bad shots were being taken.
Yeah, I think both coaches, Charlie just did right there. He noticed the 10-second count was in the offing, and he called a timeout. Coach Bressy really settled him down.
Are you one of those guys that subscribes to the idea, if you're in the backcourt, that a coach shouldn't be able to call a timeout to get the 10-second stop?
Well, they may change that rule someday, but it's a rule right now. I think another big player in this game is number 14 on the ball right now. She has 10 rebounds in this game. She is doing a job.
You're looking at Michaela Ruth. She's had a great game. And it's going to get a little too tight here.
Well, they don't want to be ruthless.
So there you have the third foul of Michaela Ruth. That'll be the 16th foul. Lancaster Catholic already has seven.
News on the West Shore. Some spraining, twisting, popping news.
She's huge in there. She needs to be in the game. She can't pick up those ticky-tacks at half court.
Wasn't much there with what you saw. There's Erin Holt breaking along the baseline. Erin Holt trying to reverse it. And it gets fouled by Essence Chisholm.
Smart play by Erin. She knew that she was going to get two foul shots out of that.
Even though it didn't look like she probably had much of a chance of making the shot, she was a little far out and just kind of threw it up, but she made sure she threw it up. That's the main thing.
Very intelligent.
14 points in the game for Erin Holt. Make it 15.
She has what you might call a high basketball IQ. I've been watching her the whole game. And she plays hard and she can shoot.
Six out of seven from the line tonight for Lancaster Catholic as a team. Erin Holt up and good. Erin Holt with 16 points in the game. Long pass down court. Corrado's got it. Corrado trying to go up, and you're going to get a foul called as quickly Bishop McDevitt had a set play there, getting it down court, got Corrado wide open.
They gave Lancaster Catholic a little bit of a dose of their own medicine, didn't they?
Julia Bright gets called for the foul. You can see Charlie Dent saying, how'd that happen? Well, here's how it happened. Got the bomb. Corrado was slipping out. And it was not Julia Bright. Well, he gave her the foul. Looked like he should have been marked him against Lauren Mills, but instead Bright gets it. Corrado scores her first time at the line tonight. She's got five. Corrado's second one is up and good. She's got a half dozen. Back to a two-point game again. Essence Chisholm will check back into the game now for Bishop McDevitt. So the heat is coming now. It's going to be a face guard, man-to-man.
Coach Bressy went defense for offense there because he also replaced number 11.
Stolen away.
And it paid dividends.
14th turnover now in the game. They haven't had one in a while. That's Lancaster Catholic. Long look. Not going to go. Look at the honey for the ball. Elsie Chisholm did a great job to get inside position but could not hang on to it.
She was there.
5:40 to go in this one. 37-35. Lancaster Catholic leads it by two. A good look, and then she has Chisholm hustling after, but goes off her hands. Deanna Nolan makes a move. Big side. Did the throw up. Not going to go. Again, you're going to get a foul. That will be on Noelle Cameron. Should be her fourth. She's heading to the line will be Annalise Schrader. Schrader aggressive and trying to get in there, and you'll see her come back at her own rebound, and then Cameron looked like she kind of swatted it out, but Got a piece of the arm on the way.
I thought Lauren Purcell was paying so much attention to Aaron Holt that she didn't really see the ball.
Annalise Schrader scored six early, has not scored since the first quarter, and there she is here in the fourth, knocking down a big free throw.
She's back.
So Schrader makes her first. Schrader's second one up. That one rattle out. Chris McDevitt covers it. Purcell brings it into the forecourt. Double team again. Stolen away. And then finishing up is Knowlton. That's what they'll do to you so quickly.
Well, the fans were clamoring for a backcourt. If they'd have called that, they'd have cost him a basket.
Here comes Chisholm. Chisholm may have got away with a walk there. Sal sets it up. Big moment in this game. 5-point lead for Lancaster Catholic. 4:50 to go. And there's the throwaway. Another turnover against Bishop McDevitt. Third one of this quarter already. 10 points off 12 turnovers for Bishop McDevitt. 10 points Lancaster Catholic has cashed in. Julia Bright being hounded. Gets it back out to Lauren Mills. Julia Bright. Ball loose on the floor. We got a jump ball. And the ball will stay with Lancaster Catholic.
Good hands by Michaela Ruth to knock that one loose.
Don't forget, we'll have our 1847 Financial Player of the Game coming up, and also our Lord Law LLC Play of the Game. And that one knocked out of bounds by Bishop McDevitt.
Hannah Knowlton tried to draw a foul and wasn't rewarded for that. Apparently it was all ball.
Back inside, little high-low, Knowlton. Knowlton with a nice turnaround, puts it away. Hannah Knowlton.
Give credit to Lauren Mills for that nice entry pass, too.
Timeout on the floor, 42-35. Lancaster Catholic leads it on High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27.
HoffmanFord.com, turning the World Wide Web into the worldwide wow. Find the newer pre-owned Ford you want right now from your computer. Shop online 24/7, 365. And our exclusive inventory is updated daily. With hundreds of new and used vehicles, you're sure to find the one that clicks. Hoffman Ford, Harrisburg's premium Ford dealer for 60 years. Click on or come by.
We talked about the outside game a while ago. How about the inside game, too? Off transition, you see Hannah Knowlton put it away after a great steal. Then you bring it back down there, and Hannah Knowlton is the girl that can get up and in a hurry. She's the girl that runs the full court and then pick it up inside. How about that little turnaround post? Use the backboard as your friend.
Wow, she found the glass all three of those shots.
So Hannah Knowlton supplementing the outside game of Aaron Holt with a great inside game here tonight. Especially stepping in for Caroline Scarf to pick up the slack. 7-point lead for Lancaster Catholic, 4:15 to go, and Bishop McDevitt and need him a bucket.
Knowlton's also had gained six, garnered six rebounds, too, so that's a big game.
So you're thinking about our 1847 Financial Player of the Game yet, Mr. Thompson?
I have been. I don't think this game's quite yet over, but Aaron Holt, her intelligence and her leadership, I think, strike me.
A lot of players. Rachel Corrigan's had a fantastic game. Michaela Roos had a really good game.
I like Michaela Roos' game.
Hannah Knowlton has played well on the inside.
Lauren Mills handled the ball very well.
And a lot of people out there tonight could be considered on this one. There's the inside look thrown away instead by Lancaster Catholic. Up hard to the basket. Putting it away nicely is Brianna Bresky. Brianna Bresky with her first deuce of the night.
And it was a finger roll.
It's a double team. And it's going to stay with Lancaster Catholic. 5-point game, 3:13 to go as we rumble down the stretch here. Every possession now getting magnified. You always see, you get the 4 minutes, it becomes a coach's game. You always subscribe to that, Jeff?
Well, I think it's a coach's game the whole time, but unfortunately, the players are the ones that win or lose it for you.
Oh, great pass inside. Good block, though. Brianna Bresky again. Nice piece of defense.
Gary, I've had teams that I would like to win by 10 points with, because you're just not sure at the end of the game.
Here goes Michaela Ruth, hard to the basket. Whoa. Michaela Ruth takes it home. Michaela Ruth with 9 points in this one.
She's close to a double-double. That's 9 points and 10 rebounds.
Back to a three-point game now, but Bishop McDevitt will not go away. And then the throw to the backcourt. Holt finds it. Holt driving hard to the basket. Holt puts it up. Not going to go. Rebounded. Who else? Bresky. Hold on her in the backcourt. I'm not positive about that call. If she put her left hand on the ball, it was a double dribble.
But otherwise, it wasn't.
She jumped up in the air. Now, take a look at this. Doesn't say you can't do it. So what? I don't know that that was right. It's one of those calls that looked, if you're an official, it had to look like something was wrong.
Technique. That was a call on technique.
Yeah, but I'm not sure. We couldn't really see the left hand. The official had a much better angle than we did.
Here's trouble.
Got it covered up, and there's going to be a throwaway for Trinity. 14 turnovers now for Trinity. 14 for Bishop McDevitt. And we got a timeout on the floor. We'll take one as well. 42-39. We've got a good one here at Lancaster Catholic, and you're watching it on High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27.
No regrets.
If only she'd parked in a garage.
No regrets.
If only she'd parked in a garage. If only they had the chimney cleaned. If only they had Erie Insurance. Erie is seriously good insurance that treats you fairly and goes above and beyond to make you feel like your auto or home mishap never happened, at rates that'll save you as much as the other guys. So get a quote from Erie today, because whatever your regrets in life, your insurance company shouldn't be one of them. Erie Insurance.
Welcome back to Lancaster Catholic. 2:09 to go. Bishop McDevitt has the ball, and they're down by three, 42-39.
And you're right, Gary. The coaches are working hard on these timeouts.
You got two good ones out there. Let's see what they come up with. Rachel Corrigan trying to get over. She's being guarded over there by Annalise Schrader. Underneath, Ruth has a block. Rebound. I'll tell you what, Brianna Bresky is all over the place right now. She goes and gets the offensive rebound and gets fouled on the play. Take a look at Bresky.
Yeah, it's like a baseball player just plays well in the World Series. Last 4 minutes of the game, all of a sudden she's come out of her shell.
Foul on Erin Old. It's her fourth. Make that her second, rather. Her second. Get it right. Bresky's first one. Big free throws right now. Bresky up and good.
It's like a coming out party for her. She's a debutante.
3 points in the game for the sophomore. Corrado will step out. Noel Cameron back in.
Coach Joe is going with defensive pressure off this shot.
Bresky gets a shooter's roll, has 4 points. 1 point game stolen away underneath by Rachel Corrigan. And then stolen right back. Back to the basket, hard drive, not gonna go. Rebounded by Schrader. Back outside, Lancaster Catholic with a 1 point lead, 1:30 to play.
Huge offensive rebound.
Julia Bright, they're just weaving right now, not really looking for much of anything. They got the 1 point lead. The heat's still on here from Bishop McDevitt.
Hard screen.
1:12 left.
That's too much time to do this, in my opinion.
There's the push through. You're going to get a foul called on Lauren Purcell. That'll be the ninth team foul. And for Purcell, that's only her second, but that's going to send them to the line. Should be 1-1. Take a look. Just go right through the screen. That's a pretty easy call to make. So now the heat rolls over to Annalise Schrader to keep her team on top. 8 of 12 so far tonight. It's Ortiz to the line, make it 9 of 13. Annalise Schrader with 8 points in this one.
There's enough time. McDevitt has to keep their poise defensively.
So now you want to make it a long possession here, in other words, a 3. Big win by Schrader. Schrader up. And good. Schrader says nothing to this. 3 out of 4 from the line. We'll take a timeout. It's High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27. 3-point lead for Lancaster Catholic. 1:05 to go. We'll be right back.
You already know your Giant bonus card is a great way to bag real savings on groceries. But it does so much more, like helping you pump up your fuel discount with gas extra rewards. Just by using your Giant bonus card, you'll save 10 cents per gallon for every $100 you spend. So the more you buy, the more you save. Gas extra rewards, fueled by Giant.
10 out of 14 for the line so far for Lancaster Catholic, so they've been good from the charity stripe, especially coming down the stretch. I saw Charlie Dentz over in the Lancaster Catholic huddle saying, you know, we got to watch that 3 right now. On the other side, Joe Bressy's probably saying something along the lines of, you know what, we got a lot of time left here. A deuce or a 3 is fine. We can still get back and play defense and get another possession created.
I saw a look of consternation on Joe's face after that last foul because he knew that it was a one-possession game, and it's hard to stall for a minute. Although at the same time, Lancaster Catholic is hitting their foul shots down the stretch.
For Lancaster Catholic right now, you're going to probably try to keep the pressure in the backcourt but not foul because their next foul, both teams, double bonus.
2 shots.
There you see the boys getting ready for the next game. Malik Gant standing over there at the doorway.
Would you call that chomping at the bit?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he says, put me in, coach. I want to play. Let's go. There you see a few of the fans in the play side. Nice crowd here this evening. I'll tell you, fans here in District 3 have seen a lot of basketball this week. And they're checking at the table right now. Joe Bressy has a question of Tom Strickler. And I think there's a discrepancy in the score.
Right now, the coaches become lawyers, don't they?
Well, the coaches feel a little bit helpless because you're going to have an official book there. And what they're doing is they're checking the book, and apparently there's a discrepancy. And there's only one official book down there.
Which is why communication's key between the scorekeepers.
Now they're going to say, yeah, we'll do about the timeout situation. Just got an indication up here. So now they're saying each team has one. Oh, wait a second.
He's giving a lot of different signals.
Tom Strickler looks like he's bringing a ship in. 2 timeouts left for Bishop McDevitt, 1 timeout left for Lancaster Catholic, and everybody seems like they're okay with that. But good job on the official there, just making sure, taking his time, and a little smile to boot at the end. So
good, very good game management.
Nice work there. Officials have done a nice job of this one tonight. Tom Strickler, Chad Weaver, and Jay Gallagher have been your officials all evening long. So Bresky has it. Soft pressure this time from Lancaster Catholic. They don't want to foul. Who are you looking to here?
Corrigan.
Corrado pulls up. Corrado off the front of the iron. Bresky coming home again. Brianna Bresky has turned into star of this game in the last 3 minutes for Bishop McDevitt.
It's Brianna Bresky time.
Charlie Detz gets a sub into the game. Both coaches are working hard right now. There's Noel Cameron back in there. You see Bresky coming in here. Bresky's all over the place. The sophomore getting it done.
She's been impressive the last few minutes.
Oh, has she ever, Jeff? 6 points in the game for Bresky. 1-point lead. 43 seconds to play here. Lancaster Catholic has the ball. Can they hang on? Ball's going to be off Rachel Corrigan, who double-teamed there. Nice job.
That was very dangerous for Lancaster Catholic.
Better not take any chances right now of your Lancaster Catholic as quickly they get Lauren Mills into the game. A little taller look there and a nice pressure release.
They're set now.
Holt doubled in the backcourt. Holt trying to find an open person. She gets it back to Bright. 33 seconds to go. Double team to get out front. Holt trying to break away from it. She does. Loses it. Michaela Ruth on it. And here comes Bishop McDevitt with a chance to win it or tie it, and a timeout on the floor. 21.7 seconds to go. 44-43. Lancaster Catholic leads on High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27.
From Times Square to your local community, from local sports to international conventions, Invica has changed the broadcast and video landscape, bringing professional quality and service to organizations across the globe. Through professional, college level, and local sports, festivals, competitions, parades, and telethons, conferences, and commercials, Invica is bringing the power of video to more people and markets than ever before. Have a project you need covered? Check out our website for more information. Invica, providing affordable HD video solutions.
The 17th turnover for Lancaster Catholic, a huge turnover here potentially. Aaron Holt doing a great job of breaking away from the pressure and then loses control. Michaela Ruth, who's been all over the place tonight on the floor, gets it back to her team and a timeout called a half court. And that's where we stand right now. A one-point lead for Lancaster Catholic, and it's Crusaders against Crusaders tonight here. All you need is a deuce to win this thing.
And foul shots may come into play here. Both teams shooting two.
Every Charlie Detz just told your team no free layup there. Here's Preston, who has been hot. Trying to find Purcell. Purcell going to take it herself to the basket. Purcell takes it up. Misses it. Rebound. Corrado had it. Jump ball. Stays with Bishop McDevitt. 11.4 seconds to go. They had Purcell on a clear out play. She went up
very strong.
Hard. Knowlton did a nice job of keeping a good angle and not letting her really get a good clean line. So 11.4 seconds to get it inbounds to Corrigan. Throw it out to Michaela Ruth. Michaela Ruth back out to Purcell. Michaela Ruth goes up. Michaela Ruth just off the front of the iron. 2 seconds to go. One. Lancaster Catholic wins it 44-43. We'll be back with our player of the game right after this on High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27.
Okay, let's see what you got.
Living Well with a Disability is a free source for anyone with any type of disability. We provide countless resources and endless opportunities to live your best.
I really am living well.
Call 1-877-2-LIVE-WELL to discover resources available for you.
Karen has 459 friends, but none of them made sure she got home okay. None of them suggested she skip the next drink, try a glass of water, or maybe just call it a night. Karen has 459 friends. But tonight, what she really needed was one good one.
The Advanced Hoops basketball program has professional skill training. Advanced Hoops is unique as we offer professional point guard and dribbling with Gerald Jarman.
As a former point guard at the University of Richmond, I led one of the greatest upsets ever against Syracuse in 1991. I get more fulfillment out of teaching young athletes the things that I learned and the keys that I learned both in college and professionally.
Charlie Fortney's shooting instruction is amazing. He's helped many high-level players get a great shooting foundation for the college level.
Guys, just in time.
When Julie wanted to provide some stability for her two boys, she reached out to the Pennsylvania Housing Finance Agency for her home loan. We're proud we could help Julie and her family. If you're looking for an affordable home loan or refinancing option, give us a call. We offer down payment and closing cost assistance too. Call us weekdays 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. or check our website. We're the Pennsylvania Housing Finance Agency. We help homeownership dreams come true.
And welcome back to High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27. Lancaster Catholic wins at 44-43 in a thriller. Bishop McDevitt had a chance to win it at the end. Michaela Ruth's shot just went off the front of the iron. Aaron Holt sitting here still breathing a sigh of relief, right?
Yeah, definitely.
Well, Aaron, you're our 1847 financial player of the game tonight here on High School Sports Live. 16 points tonight, but you did it defensively. You looked to be a good passer all night long, and you hit those threes, four of them tonight. Great night. Congratulations to you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
What do you think of the game tonight? Talk a little bit about the mindset going through that game.
Well, we came into it. This is our fourth tough game of the week. So we came in and we were 3-0, and we really wanted to make it 4-0. And with Scarf missing tonight, we all said as a team, we'll step it up and we'll win it for her.
You know, it's interesting. You've won four games this week by a total of 6 points now. Is your blood pressure up at all?
Definitely. It's been a really intense week. It's been really brutal, but it's been really fun too.
I was very impressed by the way you handled the ball. I know you can shoot it. We all knew that. But you handled the ball very efficiently. And that was huge. And plus, you defensively. And I think maybe the biggest play was when they set that trap on you, most people would go lose the ball and foul. If you would have fouled, that might have been the game. You might have lost the game, and you kept your composure. You were very intelligent tonight.
Thank you. Yeah, when I lost it, I knew I couldn't foul, so that was my mindset.
What did Coach Dett say to you defensively in that last timeout when Bishop McDevitt was setting their last play?
He said, don't foul and box out was the main key.
Well, you got away with one there, a big win. Bishop McDevitt comes in here, plays well tonight, but Lancaster Catholic pulls it out. Fourth game this week. You want to play another one tomorrow?
Oh, definitely.
You're ready to play all the time,
of
right?
Of course.
Congratulations again
Thank
for being our 1847
much.
Financial player of the game. And our play of the game tonight brought to you by Lord Law LLC. We want to take a look at this. And it had to do with Lauren Purcell with a great drive here in the first half. And it's on the monitor here behind us. But she was a handful tonight, wasn't it? You two were kind of going at each other all evening long.
Yeah, I've played Lauren since I was in seventh grade. So we played against each other a lot. And so it's always
what kind of rivalry is this with two Catholic schools, both of them Crusaders? I said if you're a Crusader fan tonight, you're going to win.
Yeah, it's definitely one of our biggest games of the year always. We always play Bishop McDevitt. And it always gets intense.
Well, congratulations. Also congratulations on already wrapping up the Section 4 championship as of last night. Your team 11-0, and you can't lose it, right?
Right.
So you're already in the league championships. So a great night, a great week for Aaron Holt and the Crusaders here of Lancaster Catholic. She is our 1847 financial player of the game. We'll be back with more after this on High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27.
No regrets.
If only she parked in a garage. If only they had the chimney cleaned. If only they had Erie Insurance. Erie is seriously good insurance that treats you fairly and goes above and beyond to make you feel like your auto or home mishap never happened. At rates that'll save you as much as the other guys. So get a quote from Erie today. Because whatever your regrets in life, your insurance company shouldn't be one of them. Erie Insurance.
And welcome back to High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27. Gary Sutton and Jeff Thompson with us here. And your thoughts about the game, Jeff, final wrap up.
What a game. What a game. It could have gone either way. At the very end, player of the game was in doubt to the last, very last second. I thought we had several really good candidates, but what really jumped out at me was how hard the teams played and how well played it was at the very end.
How about Lauren Purcell tonight handling the point there, getting some great buckets. Rachel Corrigan, unbelievable. 14 points tonight, including four threes. You have Michaela Ruth with 9 points, hustling everywhere. Shame she missed the last shot there. She got a pretty good look at it, just couldn't quite get it to go down. And a 44-43 win tonight here for the Crusaders of the Lancaster Catholic side. For Bishop McDevitt, a good accounting of themselves here tonight. But they'll walk out of here with a loss, and they get back to league play next week. Thanks so much for being with us here in this opening game. Thanks to our Invica production team, and our next broadcast is coming up here in just a few moments as the boys of Lancaster Catholic take on the boys of Bishop McDevitt. It should be a good one, and it'll all be right here on High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27.
PAC Financial, helping local families build, manage, and protect their retirement savings. Do you have a game plan for retirement? Steve Morazzo is a local advisor who listens and cares. No account too small or too large. Call Steve Morazzo at 717-564-6400 and ask about the free no-obligation retirement projection. Penn National Insurance and Inservco Insurance Services are teaming up to help all drivers feel secure. Drivers who text while driving are putting themselves and others in dangerous paths. Don't text and drive. To feel more secure, read our driver safety tips by going to www.pennnationalinsurance.com.
You already know your Giant bonus card is a great way to bag real savings on groceries. But it does so much more. like helping you pump up your fuel discount with Gas Extra Rewards. Just by using your Giant bonus card, you'll save 10 cents per gallon for every $100 you spend. So the more you buy, the more you save. Gas Extra Rewards, fueled by Giant.
It's always better when you get to pick your team. That's why I didn't just accept the regional health plan offered at work. I went to a Highmark Direct store and picked a more affordable plan with a broader network, one that I feel better with.
For the most value, you're better with Blue. We're reinventing affordable health care for today and for generations to come. For all you do, you're better with Highmark Blue Shield.
Navarro & Wright has been serving the Harrisburg area for 18 years as a leader in civil engineering, specializing in water supply and treatment, wastewater systems, land development, land surveying and mapping, and much more. For more information, call 717-441-2216.
Okay, let's see what you got.
Living Well with a Disability is a free source for anyone with any type of disability. We provide countless resources and endless opportunities to live your best.
I really am living well.
Call 1-877-2-LIVE-WELL to discover resources available for you.
No regrets.
If only she parked in a garage. If only they had the chimney cleaned. If only they had Erie Insurance. Erie is seriously good insurance that treats you fairly and goes above and beyond to make you feel like your auto or home mishap never happened, at rates that'll save you as much as the other guys. So get a quote from Erie today, because whatever your regrets in life, your insurance company shouldn't be one of them.
Erie Insurance.
HoffmanFord.com, turning the World Wide Web into the worldwide wow. Find the newer pre-owned Ford you want right now from your computer. Shop online 24/7, 365. And our exclusive inventory is updated daily. With hundreds of new and used vehicles, you're sure to find the one that clicks. Hoffman Ford, Harrisburg's premium Ford dealer for 60 years. Click on or come by.
Today, we have some breaking news on the West Shore. Some spraining, twisting, popping news. It appears that Mechanicsburg is getting a state-of-the-art OSS orthopedic urgent care. This is what we know so far. OSS urgent care is much faster than the emergency room. All patients will be seen by orthopedic experts. Costs are typically less, and OSS is open 7 days a week. Remember, if you have a sprain, pop, or break to report, go right to the experts. OSS orthopedic urgent care. Two great locations, York and now Mechanicsburg. Now that's some good news.
Register now.
This year, Advanced Hoops is offering three levels of AAU basketball: silver, gold, and Team Pennsylvania National Showcase. Fifth to 12th grade, join a championship level program. Register now, advancedhoops.com.
What you got?
Living Well with a Disability is a free source for anyone with any type of disability. We provide countless resources and endless opportunities to live your best.
I really am living well.
Call 1-877-2-LIVE-WELL to discover resources available for you.
You already know your Giant bonus card is a great way to bag real savings on groceries. But it does so much more, like helping you pump up your fuel discount with gas extra rewards. Just by using your Giant bonus card, you'll save 10 cents per gallon for every $100 you spend. So the more you buy, the more you save. Gas extra rewards, fueled by Giant.
Karen has 459 friends. But none of them made sure she got home okay. None of them suggested she skip the next drink, try a glass of water, or maybe just call it a night. Karen has 459 friends. But tonight, what she really needed was one good one.
Second half of our doubleheader tonight here at Lancaster Catholic High School. It's High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27. It's the boys' turn now. The Crusaders on both sides. Bishop McDevitt coming in here with an 11-2 record. They lead the Mid-Penn Keystone Conference. On the other side, you have a Lancaster Catholic team who comes in 11-5, and they're in second place and staying very, very close to the back of Lancaster Mennonite there. Good evening, everyone. I'm Gary Sutton. Alongside of me is Warren Goodling and also Jeff Thompson tonight, and we're going to be bringing you this second game, and it's going to be a good one. Warren, when we talk about Lancaster Catholic, you talk about balanced scoring with Coach Joe Klazis, and you start out with a guy named Tom Gonzalez.
Well, Tom Gonzalez can score a lot of different ways, and he has another guard with him, Grant Conway, who can get in the paint and find easy layups for other players. He can also finish.
On the other side, you got a high-flying team that has three scorers averaging over 15 points a game. But you really start with Malik Gantz, Jeff.
Well, I think you have to. He was nominated for the McDonald's All-Star Game. He's improved his outside shooting. He only had a couple of threes last year. I think he might have 9 or 11 this year. He goes to the basket, and he's been in double figures every game he's played, and that's 11. So I think you have to look at Malik first.
Warren, looks like you might have a game tonight of really tough defense for Lancaster Catholic to hold down this high-flying Bishop McDevitt team.
Well, Lancaster Catholic's not going to gamble on defense. They're going to keep the ball in front of them and make McDevitt earn their baskets.
On the other side, we talked about high-flying. It's a circus act out there for Bishop McDevitt. They like to run up and down the floor.
They will gamble. Coach Gaffey is a gambler. He's a riverboat gambler. They'll play all kinds of zone defenses. You'll see every one that there is.
So for all these Crusaders tonight, who's going to win the gamble? Who's going to win the sure thing? We're about to find out on High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27. Back with the game right after this.
Hey, guys, just in time.
When Julie wanted to provide some stability for her two boys, she reached out to the Pennsylvania Housing Finance Agency for her home loan. We're proud we could help Julie and her family. If you're looking for an affordable home loan or refinancing option, give us a call. We offer down payment and closing cost assistance too. Call us weekdays 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. or check our website. We're the Pennsylvania Housing Finance Agency. We help homeownership dreams come true.
I know what you're thinking. This is that little Charlie Fortney again. But this is a whole new year. I spent more time with my teammates working on dribbling with Gerald. He's amazing. Shooting with my dad. He doesn't miss. And passing. And 5-on-5 concepts are really fun.
It's all coming together. What do you say, guys?
Advanced Hoops.
Okay, let's see what you got.
Living Well with a Disability is a free source for anyone with any type of disability. We provide countless resources and endless opportunities to live your best.
I really am living well.
Call 1-877-2-LIVE-WELL to discover resources available for you.
You already know your Giant Bonus Card is a great way to bag real savings on groceries. But it does so much more, like helping you pump up your fuel discount with Gas Extra Rewards. Just by using your Giant Bonus Card, you'll save 10 cents per gallon for every $100 you spend. So the more you buy, the more you save. Gas Extra Rewards, fueled by Giant.
Is it Kevin or Chad on this?
You already know your Giant Bonus Card is a great way to bag real savings on groceries. But it does so much more.
Did we already play the interview?
Helping you pump up your fuel
the opener?
With Gas Extra Rewards.
Yeah, my mic wasn't on there when I called back. You wasn't.
You'll save 10 cents per
gallon. He said, gentlemen, we're in. I went, oh, my God.
$100 you spend.
Hey, at halftime, I got John J. Buffone, B-U-F-F-O-N-E.
Gas Extra Rewards, fueled by Giant.
And welcome back to Lancaster Catholic High School. About 3:34 left on the clock here. And it's Bishop McDevitt against Lancaster Catholic tonight here. A great interleague matchup brought to you by Pennsylvania Housing Finance Agency. It's the Lancaster Lebanon League against the Mid-Penn. Warren Goodling with me tonight. Jeff Thompson. Warren, you're the longtime coach at Hempfield. In fact, a lot of people, and I was telling someone this week, I said I was so excited about working with you because you and I coached the first game against each other we ever coached in basketball back in, what, 1974, 75 or something?
January 1974.
You actually remember that?
I remember that,
Do you remember the score?
No, I don't.
23-17, you guys won. He was coaching the 7th and 8th grade team for Northeastern. My dad actually hired Warren, and I was coaching down at Susquehannock then, and it's been a lot of games since. Jeff Thompson has been – is there any place you haven't coached yet so far? You've coached a lot of schools. You've been Trinity.
I think every county in the mid-state. But Warren and I also go way back, too.
Yeah, you guys play together a little bit, too, right?
Well, he worked for my brother at Shippensburg.
There you go. Roger Goodling, who was an outstanding coach at Shippensburg for a long time. Of course, you played at Shippensburg.
Lock Haven,
I forgot.
Bald Eagle, he's a Bald Eagle.
One of the West York Bulldogs in the early days. And where'd you play at, Jeff?
Well, we actually scrimmaged. I played at Dickinson, and we scrimmaged the Bald Eagles in 1972. So I've known Warren for quite some time.
So there you go. So we've got two great coaches up here on the deck with us tonight. But more importantly, we've got a great game setting up here as well. Warren, you talked about Lancaster Catholic. You know, they're doing a great job this season. You said they're not going to take a lot of chance in this game. Joe Classes is a coach who's played here at Lancaster Catholic. He has good lineage from here. But they're a team that knows that they've got to kind of contain tonight and not so much take shots.
Yeah, I don't think they're going to extend their defense. They're going to try to get back in a transition defense, keep everything in front of them, box out and rebound.
If you were to look at a key tonight for Lancaster Catholic, what's it going to be to this game?
Number one, you cannot turn the ball over. Number two, you got to survive on the defensive boards.
Yeah, Bishop McDevitt loves to go to the offensive glass. Jeff, Bishop McDevitt's got three guys. Mark Ray, 15.3 points a game. You got James Williams at 15.2. And then you got Malik Gantz, who's only played 10 games, but we've seen his act already in terms of being a point guard. He really makes him the go, and he loves to put a little flash on the game as well. So they will be kind of just the opposite in trying to push the pace of the game, I would think, full court.
Polar opposites. Malik really has quite a game, and he's got a lot of mustard in his game. But I would say that they have some offensive firepower, and what Warren's saying is exactly true. Lancaster Catholic has to do something to not allow that firepower to get ignited.
Bishop McDevitt, the number one team ranked in the district right now. They lead the Mid-Penn Keystone, and it's going to be an interesting one here to see tonight what gives in this game. Does a half-point court game really favor Lancaster Catholic more, Warren?
Absolutely.
And a full court game, Jeff, no doubt about it.
No doubt about it.
So we're going to see what goes here tonight. Your officials this evening, Mel Newcomer, one of the deans of the Lancaster Lebanon League officials, Brian Miller, and you've also got Brad Kohler out there. Make that Brian Mullen, rather, and Brad Kohler. So you see the crowd that's gathered for this one tonight. It's a clash of two leagues. Mike Gaffey, the coach of Bishop McDevitt, took over for Jeff Hoke, who was so successful last year. And on the other side, you got Joe Klazis, who is going to be coaching for Bishop McDevitt. There you see Mel, newcomer in the middle, a guy who's been around this game for a long, long time as an official. And so we're getting ready for our introductions here in just a moment. Lancaster Catholic will be wearing white, purple, and gold tonight. On the other side, blue, gold, and white for Bishop McDevitt. Let's go down to our PA announcers, who's courtside. And the first one introduced, Reggie Hopkins, wearing number 11. Nick Gemmel, 14. The guy we're talking about, Malik Gantz. Averaging 17 and a half a game. You'll see with the point guard a lot tonight. Mark Ray getting 15.3 a game, wearing 23. And finally, wearing number 24 tonight, James Williams, also getting 15 points a game. That's your starting lineup for Bishop McDevitt. And now for the Crusaders of Lancaster Catholic, both teams, mascots of Crusaders this evening. And Joe Zukas, averaging 10 points a game, is introduced. Where's number 3? Wearing number 11 tonight, Chad Wenger. Wearing number 15, one of their leading scorers, Grant Conway, at 12 points a game. Number 22, another leading scorer, Tom Gonzalez, averaging 12 a game. And finally, Sean Landis will be a forward. Number 23, Lancaster Catholic comes in with a record of 11-5, doing well in terms of the district rankings. On the other side, Bishop McDevitt is atop the district rankings with an 11-2 record. Final thoughts, guys, in just a few moments. But first, I believe we're going to have our national anthem here in a minute. Nope, they say no national anthem. We had it in the first game. Warren, final thoughts before we get this one underway.
Well, you're getting close to playoff time. Hard to believe, but it's only a couple weeks around the corner, and this is a great experience for both teams to play in like a playoff atmosphere somewhat.
Yeah, you're going to have that here tonight, no question about it. Jeff, final thought.
Well, I totally agree with Warren. This is a great atmosphere for basketball, and I'm really excited to see this thing tip off.
Well, we're ready to get it underway now. It'll be Lancaster Catholic going to your left, Bishop McDevitt to your right. Jumping up in the middle, and it's controlled by Bishop McDevitt. Long look for the outside immediately, nothing but air. As Mark Ray, I might have been the quickest shot I've ever seen off a jump ball without a layup.
Yeah, that was a quick one, yeah. And Lancaster Catholic has to like that defensive possession. But here's what they can't do, turn the ball over.
If there's a turnover in the baseline right away, you're going to get a jump ball here, so they won't lose it. Lancaster Catholic will get it back. Bishop McDevitt, the defending mid-Penn champions from last year.
They want to make a 90-foot game.
Well, Jeff, this court is 84 foot.
Well, then they can't make it a 90-foot game.
Yeah, that's right.
Here's Lancaster Catholic. Got a lot of motion, a lot of back doors. Keep everybody in business. There's a throw up here in the basket, not going to go off the hands of Chad Wenger. And taken back, here's Gantz throwing the ball forward. Pull up, 20 feet, knocked down. Nick Gemmel with a juice to start the game just inside the arc.
They might have a one-pass rule.
Well, they certainly want the up-tempo. That's obvious.
Lancaster Catholic will try to make long possessions here. Hard drive, the back door. Oh, what a block by Malik Gantz. Looked like an easy layup. Gantz comes in with the defensive play of the game, and then the hard move on the other end to finish it off. Gantz all over the place there, and James Williams with the easy deuce, but give Malik Gantz the credit, and then on the other end, right back at him, comes Thomas Gonzalez.
How about that, a block and an assist from Malik Gantz?
Well, he's an all-around player. I saw him at the Henfield tournament, and he put on a show both nights.
Boy, rattled in and out that time for Nick Gemmel. Good pass inside. Go up strong. Another block by Gantz. Tipped out of bounds off blue. Off white, rather. It's going to belong to Bishop McDevitt.
Now, Jeff, inside. I like to see the inside guy use his left hand on that side.
Well, he has to do something to defend off Malik, or Malik's going to have 20 blocks.
Malik Gantz so far is roaming that middle pretty well, establishing his credibility early. And you see the move there by Mark Ray. He was going to the basket no matter what.
And there was some help coming from Lancaster Catholic. They were really sagged in the lane that time.
Take a look at this block here by Malik Jansen, the replay back there. And then the transition play. Get the block coming from the weak side and then start the play. Get it ahead to your teammate and let him finish it off for you. How's that? All being handled by Mark Ray. Ray trying to go to the basket, pulls up, kicks it back out. You're going to get a three in the corner. That extra pass off the iron. Torn down by Sean Landis.
I'm not a big fan of that left-handed, no-look, one-handed pass, but.
And you're going to get a foul in the backcourt. Should be marked up on Reggie Hopkins. That'll be his first, team first. Warren, you got to like it when the team makes an extra pass down there. And you saw Bishop McDevitt doing that. They didn't get the three to go, but
yeah,
it was a good look.
That's going to pay off for you if you can keep making the extra pass, because the defense has a hard time to help. The first time, they do a nice job. The second time, but the third and fourth time of help, it's usually not there.
Great backdoor and a wonderful finish by Joe Zoukas. Spins it the right way off the glass.
Warren, there's your left-handed shot.
Zoukas getting another steal. Zoukas going to take it up. Looks like could have been goaltended. Instead, Gonzalez follows it in for two. And Lancaster Catholic goes up by two as well.
Again, good help side defense.
Take it away one more time by Lancaster Catholic. Got three turnovers in the game thus far to one for Bishop McDevitt.
Tempo favored a Catholic right now.
And they're keeping it in that half-court game. They're not getting burned in the full-court game thus far.
Again, that was all on the backdoor cut right there. They missed a layup, but they had a nice opportunity.
Great job. Gantz dishes it off again. Gantz with another unbelievable assist. As putting it home is going to be James William. He's got 4 points. So it's tied up 6-6 here in the early going. Long look by Gonzalez, not going to go off the iron. Cleared nicely by Chad Wenger.
Warren, you think that shot was too quick?
I believe it was.
There's another turnover now against Bishop McDevitt.
You know, if your legs are Catholic and you're taking a quick shot, it's got to be like automatic. It's going to be a two-point conversion.
Kind of like you shooting.
No, not really.
So Gonzalez will handle it in the backcourt for Lancaster Catholic. 4-4-12 rather to go. 6-6. Tied up here in the early going. First quarter. Warren, you watch Lancaster Catholic. It just backdoors to death, trying to get the baseline exposed constantly. And there you go again. It's wide open.
You think about the shots that they've gotten so far. They're all at the basket because McDevitt's denying. And they go backdoor. There was a lunge. And the guy got the ball and just finished the layup.
Thomas Gonzalez with 6 points. And how about Malik Gantz tiptoeing through the tulips to get that one?
Teardrop. That was a beautiful teardrop move.
Gantz with his first deuce of the game. So we're tied again. Another backdoor, this time stolen away. Second turnover of the game now for Lancaster Catholic. And a good finish, acrobatic play.
Again,
as Mark Ray brings it home.
There's the turnover that leads to the easy bucket. So it's about completing passes right now and then getting the backdoor.
So far, 4 points off those turnovers.
McDevitt's bringing their pressure out a little bit more.
There's a drive to the basket. Again, it's another block. As Gantz came across, the official's going to say, uh-uh. And the foul is going to be called on Malik Gantz. That'll be his first, team second against Bishop McDevitt.
Fouls could play an important part in this game.
Well, Lancaster Catholic's hoping that they can get some fouls on the reaching and the block shots by McDevitt.
At the line is Grant Conway, and he's off the front of the iron on the first one, short. In the game comes John Quartz and also John Ware. Make that Rick Poyle. John Ware into the game now for Lancaster Catholic. Second one is up, also no good.
He's going to have to make those conversions.
Here comes Gantz right away, coming back. Gantz misses it, rebound Gonzalez. Ten to eight. Bishop McDevitt leads by two here in the early part of the game. Another good pass to Gonzalez, and he answers it again. 8 points in the first quarter for Thomas Gonzalez inside. Timeout on the floor. We'll take one as well. It's a 10-10 tie with 2:43 left in the first quarter on High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27.
Karen has 459 friends, but none of them made sure she got home okay. None of them suggested she skip the next drink, try a glass of water, or maybe just call it a night. Karen has 459 friends. But tonight, what she really needed was one good one.
Welcome back to Lancaster Catholic. It's a 10-10 tie, 2:43 to go here in the first quarter. And Warren, you were talking during the break with Jeff about big guys with left hands inside give people trouble.
Left-handers inside give people trouble. They don't see a left-hander every day. And when you can finish with your left hand, it's a little bit awkward. And
Thomas Gonzalez with that left hand has been dynamite so far. Being inside at the basket, there you see the second of four buckets in the game. Back to live action now. Malik Gantz pulls up, lets it go. Malik Gantz, nothing but cord.
He just showcased his three. He didn't have that one last year.
No, he did not. He was passing that off last year to some of his high-scoring teammates. 5 points in the game for Gantz. 3-point lead for Bishop McDevitt.
Coach Gaffey attributes that to assistant coach Ronnie Lamel working with him.
You're going to get a push on Nick Gemmel on the far side of Bishop McDevitt. That's his first team third.
Well, when he can make that three, just has to make it one or two times a game, people respect it, and they can't just lay off of him waiting for the drive.
The other advantage he seems to have, too, guys, the fact he's so big out there, he can look over top of you, and then he gets up in the air, and now he's really got time to get excited.
Yeah, they don't know how to guard him right now after making that three.
So Lancaster Catholic trying to answer here. Gonzalez has it again. He's been tough here in the first quarter. 8 points leads all scorers in the game. Nowhere to go that time, though, against James Williams. Again, changing the shot that time into the game was Kyrie Calley, and then quickly they turn it around on the other end, but you're going to get a walk call. So the fifth turnover against Bishop McDevitt. And it looked just for a moment like Nick Gemmel had himself a free layup, but Mel Newcomer racing down the court says, uh-uh.
Coach Gaffey's going with the fist. I believe that's man-to-man full.
Piece of defense here by Bishop McDevitt. They double back inside. Gonzalez didn't quite get his head turned that time. He wasn't able to sight it.
A little bit off balance that time.
Might have been an alter inside too by the bigs.
Clean look. All net as it's drained downtown by Nick Gemmel. He's got 5 points and the lead swells to six.
This is a crucial time now for Lancaster Catholic to stay in this ballgame here in the first quarter.
Taking time in possession, they get a good look for the three, and there it is. Knocked down by Mark Cannon.
And that's a big shot at this stage of the game, just to stay involved in it the first quarter.
Huge.
Down by a tray right now, Gantz. Another good pass, baseline. Missed shot on the baseline by James Williams, and now a chance to tie it up or pull it in one for Lancaster Catholic.
Looks like they're going for the last shot.
Kick it down to 15 seconds right now. What time do you head in for the last shot, Warren?
I think you go at about, you set up at 9, you go at 6 or 7. You can't go too early, because you'll give a transition bucket up at the other end.
Oh, and they got exactly the shot they wanted. Yeah. Point blank range, it just didn't go for
like
Gonzalez.
That.
So you worked it for the shot you wanted. And Gonzalez kind of slaps himself coming off to the side. 0.7 seconds left here going in an entertaining first quarter. He'll just get it in bounds and throw it deep, does Gantz. And not a bad effort for not seeing the basket too quickly. 16-13, end of one. Chris McDevitt leads on High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27.
The Advanced Hoops basketball program has professional skill training. Advanced Hoops is unique as we offer professional point guard and dribbling with Gerald Jarman.
As a former point guard at the University of Richmond, I led one of the greatest upsets ever against Syracuse in 1991. I get more fulfillment out of teaching young athletes the things that I learned and the keys that I learned both in college and professionally.
Charlie Fortney's shooting instruction is amazing. He's helped many high-level players get a great shooting foundation for the college level.
Okay, let's see what you got.
Living Well with a Disability is a free source for anyone with any type of disability. We provide countless resources and endless opportunities to live your best.
I really am living well.
Call 1-877-2-LIVE-WELL to discover resources available for you.
Register now.
This year, Advanced Hoops is offering three levels of AAU basketball: silver, gold, and Team Pennsylvania National Showcase. Fit to 12th grade, join a championship level program. Register now, advancedhoops.com.
Welcome back to Lancaster Catholic High School, and there you see Mike Gaffey on the side, and I know he wanted to get a shout out to his mom here tonight too.
Right, he asked me if we would give a special shout out to Eleanor Gaffey, who's Bill Gaffey's wife, and she's in the hospital right now, doing okay, but we want to say hi.
That's Bill Gaffey, a name that a lot of people remember, coaching at Susquehanna Township, and the state championships there, and one of the great guys in basketball, so we wish her the very, very best in getting well soon. Start quarter number two, and a ball lost by Lancaster Catholic, and you're going to get a foul by Lancaster Catholic on the turnaround.
Well, that time Lancaster Catholic had a little problem handling the ball, and the ball, they fouled, it might have stopped the layup, so.
Probably a smart play.
Sometimes you have to foul back there to stop a layup.
Third turnover against Lancaster Catholic. There's Gantz again pulling up, and Gantz just rattling out. Great rebound inside, though, in the attempted stick back by Kyrie Kelly. He won't get it, but it'll go to the line for two.
Let me say something about Kyrie. Last year, he played for Trinity High School. He's a dynamic athlete.
He'll go to the line for two. Joe Zuka's call for the foul will be his first, team third. Both teams with three team fouls so far.
Now, keep your eye on McDevitt hitting the offensive boards, because in the first quarter, that wasn't a big factor. See if it becomes a big factor in the second quarter.
Kelly misses his first one. He'll get a second chance here. Good look there, Kyrie Kelly. Score is up, and also no good off the back of the iron. And talk about offensive boards. There's an offensive rebound right away, and another foul on Lancaster Catholic against Chad Wenger. His first, team fourth.
Warren, I've always thought up-tempo teams were more rhythm teams. They get it going, and you're in trouble if you let them get it going.
Well, that's why you slow the game down, and the other thing, that's why you take your timeouts.
Grant Conway back into the game now for the Lancaster Catholic Crusaders, who replaced Joe Zuccas. So Bishop McDevitt up by three here with 7:17 to go until halftime.
Now notice Lancaster Catholic's defense. Everybody is towards the paint. They're letting McDevitt throw the ball around the perimeter all they want.
But they didn't allow that backdoor alley-oop, did they?
No, they were ready for that.
Nowhere to go in the baseline. Almost seems, guys, like if you can somehow beat McDevitt back down, or beat McDevitt back down the court, you got a much better chance, because once they get set in there, there's no answer inside except for maybe Gonzalez. And here comes Gonzalez back into the game. Coach must have heard me. It's a half-court game. Got to get our big guy in there.
Back in. It's a set play right here.
Get the pull up for the three. A little bit off balance. Good follow. Put it back again. And a nice stick back that time by Sean Landis staying on top of it.
That's a nice piece of work, wasn't it, Warren?
Well, it was a great second effort. The first shot, he missed it, but he stayed with it.
Here goes Gantz. Gantz switches hands twice and lays it in for a deuce. 7 points in the game now for Malik Gantz. His team leads by three.
I call that clever.
in the air.
That's just a lot of ability right there.
I don't know of a lot of drills you do to get that one down.
I guarantee it's not the first time he's done it.
What a good look outside, not going to go. Rebounded there by Mark Cannon, blocked inside by Kelly.
Kyrie with a nice rebound.
Hard drive to the basket. Another block inside, this time by Gonzalez. But Gonzalez is going to get tabbed for the foul. It'll be his first. Take a look at this. A great drive coming to the basket here, and Gonzalez trying to bring him down. Not going to happen. Timeout on the floor. We'll take one as well. It's 18-15. Bishop McDevitt leads on High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27.
You already know your Giant bonus card is a great way to bag real savings on groceries. But it does so much more, like helping you pump up your fuel discount with gas extra rewards. Just by using your Giant bonus card, you'll save 10 cents per gallon for every $100 you spend. So the more you buy, the more you save. Gas extra rewards, fueled by Giant.
And welcome back to Lancaster Catholic High School. It's 18-15. Bishop McDevitt leads Lancaster Catholic by three. There you see everybody's poured in here tonight. We got the pajama gang down there in the front row, Warren. I don't know if we didn't wear those in our day, did we?
No, they didn't. But the student sections around this whole District 3 is becoming very clever.
Giant food section over there tonight. Glad to have them here. And yeah, everybody's getting clever. The other night we saw a group of Red Lion all in Hawaiian outfit. Last night we saw the pink with the Golden Corral up at Cedar Cliff. So, man, I'll tell you what, they are out in force.
Is there a contest going on right now?
Well, neither one of these two teams is a sleeper, I can tell you that. Oh.
So the first one is up and down. I'll save you. Reggie Hopkins makes it his first points of the night. Takes his team out to a four-point bulge. And the second one up and good by Hopkins. So 20-15, Bishop McDevitt leads here. 5:47 to go until halftime. And blocked out again, this time by James Williams. Tell you what, there is nothing available easy in the lane for Lancaster Catholic.
Don't put it up soft.
See, again, just change the trajectory there. And you're going to get a foul call on Lancaster Catholic. So, Warren, the type of shots they're getting in the lane right now are not the good kind of shots out of your offense you really want.
Now, I call them high degree of difficulty shots. The higher the degree of difficulty, the lower your percentage.
First foul on Sean Landis, team six now against Lancaster Catholic. It gets stolen in the backcourt. Lost by Bishop McDevitt. That's their sixth turnover in the first half.
Good hands by Sean.
So the foul will be against Mark Ray, his first, team fourth now against, I want to say the Crusaders, but they're both Crusaders. Stolen back here by Bishop McDevitt. Take it off to Hopkins. Hopkins can't get it. Torn down by Sean Landis.
Yeah, he's doing a nice job on the boards, both ends.
And Landis going hard to basket, but he's going to get a player control foul right here. Sean Landis with his second foul. Good position on this one. This is probably as easy a call as you're going to have to make on player control. Here you'll see it again. Good give and go. Landis going to the basket, but right there, nice. Setting up, waiting for him was Mark Ray.
Great job on the help side defense.
For some of you younger players, Mark Ray has developed quite a player, and he's also grown about 8 inches in the last 2 years.
Warren, it's amazing. You talk about help side defense, and we're talking about the side away from the basketball for a lot of people out there that are wondering what that means, but here's a long shot from the corner, not going to go from Hopkins. Tracked down there by Kyrie Kelly. He tries to put it up, another foul called here. But, you know, you watch block shots, you watch charges, and in that situation where you have a help side and strong side, most of those are always going to come from the weak side of the help side.
Yeah, it's a coach's focus on getting that help side there so you're not worried about the drive as much, because you can't get a lot of help from the strong side right now because of the three ball. The strong side help leads to an open three, so you got to bring the help from the weak side.
That's a relatively new concept in basketball.
Back into the game is Sean Henry now for actually the first time tonight. He's going to be in for Gonzalez as Gonzalez picks up that magic number that sends you to the bench in the first half for almost every coach. Two. They do not want him getting three. Second shot by Kelly. He finally finds it. He's one out of four from the line. They're stretching it out slowly as Bishop McDevitt. They lead by six, largest lead of the night.
Kyrie Kelly. Kyrie Kelly is a pretty effective sixth man, isn't he?
Yes, he is. I think he had 18 points last night. And that was a zone trap by McDevitt last time. Not the man-to-man, but the zone trap.
A nice putback, and they scored two more off that 6 points off the turnover.
Trapping that first pass. And another, trapping that first pass.
Another dime by Malik.
Mark Ray gets his fourth point of the night. They stretch it out now to eight. It's lookout time right now for Lancaster County because they are swarming everywhere as Bishop McDevitt. There's a pull-up shot. Knocking it down. Stop the bleeding right there.
Beautiful pump faking.
Was that Andrew DeBoard?
Yes, it was.
Andrew DeBoard knocks it down. It's a name you hear around Lancaster County from the old days. Pretty good players. And DeBoard again. DeBoard says, I can do it again. Andrew DeBoard, a junior, 6'2". So the foul. You see DeBoard going baseline now. He says, I don't care about the trees inside. I can make a move, right?
He challenged that time. And he was trying to finish with his left hand.
So you liked all the things he was trying to get done there.
I'd like to see him make the foul shots.
That's the second one go. Kind of has a high reach on that one off the front of the iron again. Instead of reaching in the basket, that high reach to the ceiling. Both of them went off the front. So two opportunities missed there for Lancaster Catholic.
They're battling on the boards, Catholic is, I believe.
Yeah, they are. I'm sure it's a focus point to stay in the ballgame. They've got to get a lot of rebounds.
Don't forget our Ambassador Advisors halftime report coming up. We'll also have an interview with John J. Buffon, who is from Game Time PA. And on the run now is Lancaster Catholic off the missed shot. Another block from Malik Gantz. But then the stick back.
Relentless on the boards.
Another look for the outside. A little quick. Not going to go. Rebounded by McDevitt. They're going to get a foul called. Probably on Grant Conway here from behind. And there's what you were talking about earlier, Ward, about them getting on the offensive glass. They are so good to the offensive glass. You've got to take responsibility and box out your guy.
Well, you can offensive rebound with size, and you can also do it with quickness. They've got a little bit of both going on here tonight.
The first shot is up and good by Reggie Hopkins. He's 3 out of 3 for the charity stripe tonight. Nice crowd on hand here tonight. This is the time of year where you're playing a lot of games in a week. This is the fourth game this week for Lancaster Catholic. It's the third game this week for Bishop McDevitt.
And they're both ready for this one.
Yeah, they might have circled this one on Monday.
The board with it. Hands it back to Landis.
Very good patience.
Another one of those shots, and wow. Joe Zucas finds the backboard in the net. He's got 6 points in the long pass the other end. Stolen away. Seventh turnover against Bishop McDevitt. Four for Lancaster Catholic. Ball's going to be on the baseline, on the sideline, rather. Malik Gantz had his hands in there.
Lancaster Catholic executed the offensive game plan. They got back, stopped the transition for the defensive game plan. So those two pieces of the puzzle they put together in the last couple seconds.
You know, people talk about the transition game all the time, but they never talk enough about the defensive transition game, and that's one the coaches work on a lot more than anybody would think.
Well, we all know how many times we went to practice saying we're going to work on that, right?
Yeah.
Well, Coach Gaffey early in the year wasn't real happy with his man-to-man defense, and I think they've improved.
I always know we played a quick team. We like to have seven guys. We play 5-on-7, have two guys waiting in the backcourt, and then you had to run back and cover.
because it certainly seems like they have seven guys with all the quickness out there some games.
There's blue, gold, and white everywhere. There's a drive to the basket. A great move that time as Rick Hoyland drives it hard to the basket, only a sophomore. And missing on the other end is Gantz. Gantz trying to keep it alive. Taken away by Zukas. And Zukas is going to have it tied up by Nick Gemmel. The ball will stay with Lancaster Catholic.
Malik's explaining to Coach Gaffey about the last finger roll, I believe.
Here you go. Great drive to the basket. And that is actually John Ware, I believe, a sophomore. John Ware takes it in for the score. They have two number 21s here in our program, so we'll do that a couple times throughout here. Another backdoor. They had another block, but this time it's going to be a foul as well, and that's going to be on James Williams, his second foul. I was going to say to you, Warren, it looked like Lancaster Catholic was doing a little less cutting this quarter and a lot more putting the ball on the deck and driving it, but there you saw the back door again.
Yeah, they were, again, trying to deny the pass. You get to the three-point line. You don't want to catch it too far out there. You go back door after some ball movement, and you got that opportunity.
Well, and Bishop McDevitt was at a point where they could have broken this game open, and now I look at it, and one more foul shot, it's a tie game. And look at how low the score is. Whose tempo and whose favor, Coach
this
Goodling?
This is definitely in favor of Lancaster Catholic. Now, listen, Lancaster Catholic has had a lot of success over the years, and they have tremendous pride in their program. And that's why if they get down, they're not quitting. They're going to keep coming back. That's what they do.
And that's what we're seeing.
Had a state championship not all that long ago. One out of two that time for Chad Wenger. 25-24, missing the three. Yanked down again by that young man who's coming here, John Ware. Lancaster Catholic now with a minute to go has a chance to take the lead.
Just keep doing what they've been doing. Now, McDevitt's starting to switch some of those down screens. So that'll be a little bit trickier on the cutter. He's going to have to read that and go behind the switch.
Got to split those two guys because they're not going back to pick up the switch shoulder to shoulder. It's just a wide open space, so you got to cut between them. 37.4 seconds to go until halftime. Don't forget our ambassador advisors halftime report and our Highmark halftime stats. Plus, we'll be talking to John J. Buffon of Game Time PA.
Wow, Kyrie.
What a great hustle play on defense.
Oh, you're going to get a foul coming back. Fifth turnover now against Lancaster Catholic. ...25-24, and there you see, pick the pocket and then turn it around so quickly. And that's, you know, creating the new possession is a big part of it. Then finishing it off is the other half of the equation.
Well, Kyrie started the first half with great hustle, a tip ball and a dive.
Alex Marcico into the game for Bishop McDevitt, putting points on the board for the first time. Marcico's second shot up and good. It's two out of two.
Let's see if Lancaster Catholic can get what they want. Now, here's a little bit of a zone trap right now. Like you said, Jeff, here comes a lot of different, another defensive look for McDevitt. There's your steal.
And the dunk.
That was put down with impunity.
That's 12 points off turnovers so far for Lancaster Catholic. Seven turnovers. And quickly on the other end. And a missed shot just rolled out coolly that time from Mark Cannon. And that'll be the end of the first half. It's 29-24. We're at the half. We'll have the Ambassador Advisors halftime report and our interview with John J. Buffon coming up right after this on High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27.
Karen has 459 friends, but none of them made sure she got home okay. None of them suggested she skip the next drink, try a glass of water, or maybe just call it a night. Karen has 459 friends. But tonight, what she really needed was one good one.
is a place where kids really connect to learning. Commonwealth Connections Academy. It's a tuition-free, fully accredited online public school where students find devoted, enthusiastic teachers like never before. Commonwealth Connections Academy, the online public school.
From Times Square to your local community, from local sports to international conventions, Invica has changed the broadcast and video landscape, bringing professional quality and service to organizations across the globe. Through professional, college level, and local sports, festivals, competitions, parades, and telethons, conferences, and commercials, Invica is bringing the power of video to more people and markets than ever before. Have a project you need covered? Check out our website for more information. Invica, providing affordable HD video solutions.
Welcome back to our Ambassador Advisors Halftime Report here in Lancaster Catholic. We're at the half, 24-23. Bishop McDevitt leads Lancaster Catholic in a good one so far. I'm with John Buffone of GameTimePA.com. And, John, great to have you up here in the deck with us tonight.
Glad to be here. It's been a pretty exciting game so far.
Good first half. You're obviously seeing the top team right now in District 3, one of the top teams, I'll say, in the state, going up against a pretty darn good Lancaster Catholic team here as well. What are you seeing here in the first half?
Well, you're seeing a contrast of styles, obviously. If you're Bishop McDevitt, you're getting to the rim, but you're not finishing. And right. You need a million-dollar move, 10-cent finish, as it happened in all half. The problem with those fast breaks is if you don't finish, you don't have a lot of guys there to get offensive rebounds, so you're seeing a lot of it going the other way. As for Lancaster Catholic, I think Thomas Gonzalez did a great job in the first half, 8 points, but then they got in a little bit of foul trouble. Right. They got three of their starters with two fouls right now. Lancaster Catholic, they're not going to blow you away, but they are all about the execution. And so far, they're finding some seams in the Bishop McDevitt defense, and they're able to execute.
Saw a lot of blocks from Bishop McDevitt. They're not an exceedingly tall team, and yet at the same time, they are so quick off their feet, they make up for that lack of height with an abundance of quickness.
Oh, and that's absolutely what you're seeing. Whenever they're modifying a lot of shots with the bigs, whether it's Landis
right.
or Gonzalez, they're making them alter a lot of their shots. They're making them uncomfortable underneath the rim. And as the game progresses, if they are able to continue to do that, you could see the lead opening up a little bit because they're making those off-balance shots right now, a couple of them, but that's not going to last the rest of the game.
Long, wiry athletes with big reaches. Let's talk a little bit about District 3 basketball right now. We're moving into that time of year. Think about this. A month from now, we're going to be playing playoff times in the leagues and then moving into districts. Season seems like it's going by too fast. Your thoughts about District 3 right now? We got the Lancaster-Lebanon League. We got the YAIA over here next door in York County. And of course, we got the Mid-Penn. I said the other night, 7 out of the 19 teams in 4A are from Mid-Penn. We've got a bunch of those Lancaster-Lebanon teams in there. What are you seeing so far that really impresses you, and who are maybe some of the favorites and the dark horses out there?
Well, you look at throughout the LLL, the Lancaster-Lebanon League, right now you're looking at Section 3. Manheim Central's on a 14-game winning streak. They have a lot of experience. They made a state a playoff run last year, right. Came up a little short, I believe, in the first round. But they have a lot of experience coming back, and they have height. They have Taylor Funk, who's a sophomore, who started as a freshman. He's 6'7". He has range for days. They have Matt Walsh, who is 6'5", can get off the ball really well, play inside. They have a lot of experience there. They're a team that I think can probably make some noise. Not to mention, in Section 4, Lancaster Catholic, and right now on top is Lancaster Mennonite.
Right.
They're not really a team that rebuilds. They reload. And right now, they have a very dynamic duo in Mark Hall and Julian Collazo, who are electrifying. Either one of them can go off for 25, or they can both go off for 25. We kind of saw that a couple days ago in a win that they had. So they could possibly make noise. It's all about getting hot at the right time, though. These teams that, you know, have 9, 10, 11-game winning streaks, it's exciting in the regular season, but it's can you execute in the playoffs? In that, against a team that you haven't played yet, a team that you don't really know, can you prepare? And that's where the experience comes through for a lot of these teams.
We watched Susquehanna Township earlier this week. Of course, they finished second in the state last year. They played as focused a game against Hershey the other night that I've seen as I've seen them play, and they look like the team that was the runner-up last year, almost won the state championship. What are you seeing from them? Are they finally starting to gel a little bit?
Well, I think that if you can forget about the first couple games of the season, forget about the first 5 games of the season, if you can gel at the right time, if you get hot at the right time, that's basketball.
Right.
If you start peaking and you start getting that chemistry going at the right time, then it's at that point, the sky is the limit. So with them, the potential is through the roof.
Who are the state champion possibilities out there in District 3 from your standpoint?
Oh, it's tough to say at this point.
If you were sitting at the at your local restaurant right now having a Coke, and someone said, you got to pick one, who would have the best chance?
Right now, Cedar Crest in Section 1 is undefeated. And until they lose, it's hard to say that they're going to. They're playing a very very tough Section 1 with J.P. McCaskey and Hemphill, and even Warwick's making some noise right now. They're another team that's bringing back a lot of experience, and they have a lot of talent. And they also made a good run last year. Being 16-0, that's nothing to dismiss. So you got to think that if they can keep the – you don't want to peak too soon, but if they can keep that momentum going and they can keep battling these teams, they have a good chance of making some noise.
John Buffone, always great having you up here. And don't forget to read Game Time PA and check out John's columns there. We'll be back with more. It's your Ambassadors Halftime Report here on High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27.
Linden Hall, located in beautiful downtown Lititz, Pennsylvania, was founded in 1746 and is the nation's oldest independent boarding and day school for girls. Linden Hall also fuses together academic curriculum with athletic programs to give girls the well-roundedness they need to be an effective contributor in the world of the 21st century.
The world's a very competitive place, and girls need to learn how to compete. And so we're trying to teach them the hard work, diligence, sacrifice, and caring for others leads to team goals that supersede what an individual can do.
We have a vision to make our athletic department better. We understand that athletics can enhance an academic program. It is an educational athletic program.
This is finals week, so how's finals going this week?
Well.
They're going well?
How about you? I plan on going to university and studying business administration with a minor in East Asian studies.
It's really interesting to meet everyone from different areas and to learn about different cultures.
Linden Hall uniquely blends its rich heritage with today's culture to prepare students to achieve their goals for higher education and beyond.
You already know your Giant bonus card is a great way to bag real savings on groceries. But it does so much more, like helping you pump up your fuel discount with gas extra rewards. Just by using your Giant bonus card, you'll save 10 cents per gallon for every $100 you spend. So the more you buy, the more you save. Gas extra rewards, fueled by Giant.
Guys, just in time.
When Julie wanted to provide some stability for her two boys, she reached out to the Pennsylvania Housing Finance Agency for her home loan. We're proud we could help Julie and her family. If you're looking for an affordable home loan or refinancing option, give us a call. We offer down payment and closing cost assistance too. Call us weekdays 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. or check our website. We're the Pennsylvania Housing Finance Agency. We help homeownership dreams come true.
The Advanced Hoops basketball program has professional skill training. Advanced Hoops is unique as we offer professional point guard and dribbling with Gerald Jarman.
As a former point guard at the University of Richmond, I led one of the greatest upsets ever against Syracuse in 1991. I get more fulfillment out of teaching young athletes the things that I learned and the keys that I learned both in college and professionally.
Charlie Fortney's shooting instruction is amazing. He's helped many high-level players get a great shooting foundation for the college level.
Welcome back to Lancaster Catholic, where it's halftime. The Ambassador Advisors Halftime Report is 29-24. Bishop McDevitt leads. Let's take a look at our Highmark halftime stats. And 2 3-pointers to 1 3-pointer so far, not a big number. 7 out of 10 from the free throw line for McDevitt. 1 out of 6 for Lancaster Catholic. That's a big number thus far. 6 to 8 in turnovers, 16-14 in rebounds. Guys, anything jump out at you right there that kind of hits you? Warren first.
Well, Lancaster Catholic's not... They don't make a lot of threes through the season. I don't think they take their leading three-point shooters only has 15 for the year. So they don't really live by the three-point line. But right now tonight, McDevitt's playing good pressure defense on the three-point line, and that's enabling them to get some backdoors.
What's been interesting on those 8 turnovers so far for Lancaster Catholic, 12 points on the other side off those turnovers for Bishop McDevitt. On the other side off the 6 turnovers for Bishop McDevitt, only 4 points for Lancaster Catholic. So they're winning that battle in transition and then cashing them in on the other end. Jeff, your thoughts.
Well, first of all, the foul line jumps out at me, 7-1, and made foul shots. And that's the difference in the game. But I get the feeling that McDevitt's like a powder keg. They're ready to explode any second. Do you think they'll do it in the second half?
Well, it's like a tractor pull here. One trying to slow it down, one trying to speed it up. That's our ambassador's advisor's halftime report. And we're getting ready to start the second half right here. Mr. McDevitt will have the basketball in the lead. 29-24, we head to the third quarter. Looked by Reggie Hopkins. Hopkins misses it on the glass. Lancaster Catholic pulls it down, gets it to Joe Zoukas. Lancaster Catholic with a lot of motion. Drives the basket, trying to dish it off. There's Chad Wenger.
Two sloppy passes, one down here and one down here to start the half.
Little four round one setup, and that time the receiver was running the wrong direction of the pass.
Ninth turnover of the game, first of the second half down for Lancaster Catholic. Missed opportunity there. Malik Yance goes up. Malik Yance gets the roll. No. On top of it that time with James Williams. He won't get it. Finally pulled down by Gonzalez back into the game. He sat out about the last 3 minutes of the first half. Big difference when they have him in.
Yeah, there. They need him in here because he can help them down low.
Nice crossover.
Zoukas says, I got a little French pastry for you, too, out here, guys. Gonzalez looking for the back door. Not a good pass there. Thrown away again. And then the answer on the other end. And again,
that was a
points off a turnover.
You know, like we said, beginning game, key for Lancaster Catholic, don't turn the ball over. And there it led to an easy bucket the other way.
And that was a perfect pass by Malik Gantz. Perfect.
14 points off turnover so far for Bishop McDevitt. Make it another one.
Steal.
Look at Gantz. Gantz says, take it here, put it away. You might get a timeout right here called, and that's exactly what's going to happen from Joe Klazis. Big run to start the third quarter for Bishop McDevitt. 33-24, 6:21 to go on High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27.
No regrets.
If only she'd parked in a garage. If only they had the chimney cleaned. If only they had Erie Insurance. Erie is seriously good insurance that treats you fairly and goes above and beyond to make you feel like your auto or home mishap never happened. At rates that'll save you as much as the other guys. So get a quote from Erie today. Because whatever your regrets in life, your insurance company shouldn't be one of them.
Erie Insurance.
Malik Gantz gets the steal. It's a 13th turnover against Lancaster Catholic. 16 points off turnovers so far. And Malik Gantz has 9 points in this one. And he has been everything so far in this game, Jeff.
He sure has. He's done it. Rebounding, block shots, assists, steals. And Coach Goodling just told me what makes him really special is his change of pace, his ability to go slow and then a little bit faster.
Well, he has that explosiveness. And, boy, he can turn it on. The thing I like about him, he's their best player, no question about it. But he's their best passer, too. And he's very unselfish. He loves to pass the ball.
To say the least, huge possession here for Lancaster Catholic. They've got to get something. There's another throwaway, trying to do it too quickly. And right on the other end. Devitt.
They waited for Kareem.
There's Gantz again. Gantz was thinking about putting that one down. Instead, he's going to get fouled. Is it going to be on Gonzalez?
Gary, he wasn't putting it down. He was taking it over two people. I'd like to see that replay.
Gonzalez with his third foul. So you got to give Gantz some credit, too. He knew exactly who he was going at. Gantz's first shot up, no good. Malik Gantz.
Well, until they take a charge on him in this half, he's going to keep attacking the basket.
Gantz one out of two from the line. 17 points off the turnover so far. 14 turnovers by Lancaster Catholic.
And more importantly, that was Gonzalez's third foul. I don't know if we mentioned that, but he's huge. But
Gonzalez picks up his third foul. Pass going to the basket again. You have to alter it going inside there for Zoukas. And here comes Bishop McDevitt. Hey,
Yeah, they definitely know number 22 sitting in the lane there.
Yep, there it is. And they're going to work him to death right there as James Williams gets the easy bucket. He's got 4 points. That's just good coaching there, knowing exactly where the situation is, and then another tough shot, and Lancaster Catholic shooting themselves out of this right now.
That's bad that they're playing into the tempo of Bishop McDevitt.
Yeah, that's one thing you don't want to do.
Reggie Hopkins pulls it up. Hopkins parries it. Reggie Hopkins now with 6 points in this one and a 14-point lead all of a sudden.
The rhythm has changed. It's the Blues now.
Another steal. And 2 more points off that steal. And they have scored 9 points this quarter off 5 turnovers so far. Unbelievable run for Bishop McDevitt. 40-24, they lead with 4:28 to go in the third quarter. On High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27.
Today, we have some breaking news on the West Shore. Some spraining, twisting, popping news. It appears that Mechanicsburg is getting a state-of-the-art OSS orthopedic urgent care. This is what we know so far. OSS urgent care is much faster than the emergency room. All patients will be seen by orthopedic experts. Costs are typically less, and OSS is open 7 days a week. Remember, if you have a sprain, pop, or break to report, go right to the experts. OSS orthopedic urgent care. 2 great locations, York and now Mechanicsburg. Now that's some good news.
15-1 start here in the second half as you see the two huddles, and that huddle is probably a little bit more joy right now. The other huddle, the white side, Joe Klaas, is Warren Goodley, is not a happy guy right now, trying to figure out a way to slow this one back down and get it back on the tempo he wants.
Well, I think Lancaster Catholic got a little bit carried away in trying to beat my man one-on-one at times. After 2 or 3 passes, that's not working. So they're going to have to go back to executing their offense. Now they're going to face a zone press.
And it's somewhat of a feeding frenzy for Bishop McDevitt.
Maybe with the long pass opposite to Gonzalez. Gonzalez throws it up to Ware. And there on the other end, quickly off the missed shot. It's almost like a turnover. It's not, but you get a bad shot, and then they just turn it around on you right away. Hopkins in for 2 more.
You know, what I would say is the press worked. It forced a tough shot. They got the rebound and layup.
Again, you change the arc there, putting it up. Ware says, I don't want it. Gets it off to the side. Finally buried there by Sean Landis. Sean Landis with his first deuce of the night.
Yeah, they're not going to win this up-tempo game, I don't believe.
And Bishop McDevitt comes right back on you right away as soon as you make the bucket. And there's a defensive transition we were talking about. You can't forget about it here in the third quarter.
1 more. Think Catholic has one more run in him?
It's going to start on the defensive end, and
Malik Gantz just
that's where it has to start.
Wow.
Gantz with 7 points in this, or maybe that 5 points in this quarter so far. Numerous blocks and a couple great assists.
I thought that was a good defensive rebound, but no, it was a snatch by Malik in 2.
44-26. Bishop McDevitt has it going on. Should get a goaltend right there. So it'll be a goaltend and a nice job getting open. Take a look at it here. Good back door, nobody home. When you're coming over to trap, the weak side's going to be open. And Mark Cannon goes in for an easy deuce. Cannon with 5 points in this one.
Now think about the problem Lancaster Catholic has when you have to guard Malik Gantz. You can't guard him with a guard, he's too big. You guard him with the forward, he's too fast. So you got a lot of problems.
A timeout called, 3:22 to go in the third. 16-point lead for Bishop McDevitt on High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27.
Okay, let's see what you got.
Living Well with a Disability is a free source for anyone with any type of disability. We provide countless resources and endless opportunities to live your best.
I really am living well.
Call 1-877-2-LIVE-WELL to discover resources available for you.
Jeff Thompson, when you look at the coaching staff over on the side here for Coach Mike Gaffey, there's some interesting stories behind those guys.
A bunch of good assistant coaches. He did this at Penn State Harrisburg. Stan Balava used to coach at Trinity. Kenton Alston played for him at Penn State Harrisburg. George Leader went to the state finals with Halifax. His son Scott Gaffey and Ronnie Lamel. What a staff.
There's Gans from the outside shot. Stan Balava was my classmate up at Mansfield University. A heck of a shooter for the Mounties.
Stan the man from Nanticoke.
So Lancaster Catholic gets missed there from Mr. McDevitt. A chance to try to answer with some decent points. Here's a look outside. Ware can't get it to go. Rebounded inside, put back again. You're always aware of those arms outstretched. Lancaster Catholic stays alive on the offensive glass.
Two or three nice, good offensive rebounds.
Gonzalez has not scored this half. Gonzalez finally finds a way to get it inside and gets his 10th point of the night.
There's the lefty move again.
McCorm ready for the left-hander, right?
Well, he got the ball on the right side and went to the center, which is perfect for the left hand.
Good Williams, great pass. Just unselfish basketball. And Williams finds Callie coming down the lane. 3 points for Callie tonight.
He spilled it on the court, though. How about that, McLaurin?
Gonzalez stretched it out. Couldn't get it to go. Here comes McDevitt. Oh, and just a little too fast that time. That is their seventh turnover tonight. It's their first turnover here in the third quarter for Bishop McDevitt. How's that?
For a team that plays at that pace, that's not very many turnovers. I think he hit our cameraman with that pass, though.
So. Our cameraman was cat quick. Stayed out of the way. They have drills here for our Invicta camera crew. I mean, they have to learn how to be that cat quick to stay out of the way, right?
Warren, that looked like your shot right there. Pull-up jumper, great stroke.
It's 2 points in the game for Grant Conway. Turnover number 8 now in the game for Bishop McDevitt. Get back out, long look. Can you get one to go? No. Chasing it down is Ware. McDevitt just switches everywhere. And right down the lane. Nice job for Lancaster Catholic. Sean Landis in for 2. Good job out of the offense that time.
John Ware made a nice penetrate and dished. He drew the defense. I like his potential. He's only a sophomore. He looks like he's going to be a good player here.
Dug it back to 12 with under a minute to play here in the third quarter. So if you could somehow get it to 12, keep it at 12 or around 10, you're happy. There goes Callie down the lane, and Callie with another great pass from Malik.
But Callie with 5. What a touch on that shot.
Feathery.
That's to the far side now. Lancaster Catholic wants to close with some momentum here. That's the old thing about runs, Warren. You want to have the last 2 points of the quarter and the first two of the next quarter.
Yeah, that can change the momentum real fast if you can do that.
Ware loses this time going to the basket. And the ball's going to be kicked.
And he's going to learn to pick his spots on when to penetrate and when not. You know, you can't over-penetrate sometimes.
Andrew DeBoard back into the game now for Lancaster Catholic. Gets a little bit more brawn in there. Malik Yance will trigger the inbounds play.
Malik's a little winded. He really filled those lanes in a hurry.
Well, he's doing a lot for him, and times he's playing point guard, too.
Right now.
He's rebounding. He's making steals. So, you know, when you're coaching, everyone says, is he Division I? Is he Division I? There's a Division I player.
Here you go. 6 seconds to go. Gantz is going to either take it himself or pass it. He passes it. Stolen away. Long shot. Not going to go at the end of the quarter. 48-34. We head to the fourth on High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27.
Linden Hall, located in beautiful downtown Lititz, Pennsylvania, was founded in 1746 and is the nation's oldest independent boarding and day school for girls. Linden Hall also fuses together academic curriculum with athletic programs to give girls the well-roundedness they need to be an effective contributor in the world of the 21st century.
The world's a very competitive place, and girls need to learn how to compete. And so we're trying to teach them The hard work, diligence, sacrifice, and caring for others leads to team goals that supersede what an individual can do.
We have a vision to make our athletic department better. We understand that athletics can enhance an academic program. It is an educational athletic program.
This is finals week, so how's finals going this week?
Well.
They're going well?
How about you?
I plan on going to university and studying business administration with a minor in East Asian studies.
It's really interesting to meet everyone from different areas and to learn about different cultures.
Linden Hall uniquely blends its rich heritage with today's culture to prepare students to achieve their goals for higher education and beyond.
Welcome back to High School Sports Live TV. We're at Lancaster Catholic, 48-34. We go to the fourth quarter. Bishop McDevitt leads by 14, the number one team in District 3.
Coach Goodling, what are they doing defensively right now?
It's a 1-3-1 extended with the tall guy out top to make the guard-to-guard pass difficult.
So Grant Conway, they always have that tall guy out there at the top. Gets right in the halfway point. Grant Conway misses the outside shot. McDevitt comes back. Trying to get Williams inside, and there's a big mismatch there in terms of size as Williams is going to get fouled. Pushing the back. Should be called on Chad Winger, who's only 5'8", was trying to handle Williams down in the post there. Williams about 6'3".
Hey, I'm pretty impressed that McDevitt can play a quarter in 30 seconds with no fouls.
Well, there they have the 10th turnover of the game. You know, you talk about turnovers so far. They have 10 turnovers in the game. 6 points scored by Lancaster Catholic on the other side of those turnovers. On the other side, Lancaster Catholic has 14 turnovers, 19 points off that from Bishop McDevitt.
Would you call that the finishing touch?
That's what you want to have, too. You create the possession, you want to finish it off. That's what makes 100%. 50% doesn't get you anything. Ware takes it to the basket. Ware puts it up, not going to go. Plazas fouls it, tries to knock it in, can't do it. Rebounded by Gantz, and here he comes, and the foul in the backcourt will be called against Chad Winger, his third foul. His third foul, team fourth of the second half. There you see it in the backcourt, and just try to slow Gantz down.
Yeah, you're going to have to try to slow him down. With him handling the ball out top, he gets to the basket a lot of different ways, off a ball screen. He doesn't really need a ball screen most of the time. But if you help off, he's going to find the shooters, and that's what happened earlier in the game.
Gantz dribbling, baseline floats, puts it up, rolls out of the rim. Good move by Gantz.
Good move. He was challenging.
Well, he had three guys tried to help on that time, so that made that shot a little harder than what it normally is for him.
There's DeBoer again. I like what I've seen from DeBoer tonight in the game so far. He likes to go to the rack.
How about those hands by Malik? Took one off the stomach.
Gantz is going to get called for the player control foul. Good job in there by Grant Conway to take the foul. Take a look at this. Here's Gantz and trying to weave his way through, and there you see it. Conway holds his ground.
Yeah, good play by Grant, and hopefully that, for Lancaster Catholic, maybe that'll discourage Malik Gantz from penetrating.
How many fouls does Malik have? That's his second.
Malik Gantz with his second foul so far. That's only the first team foul here in second half against Bishop McDevitt, 4-1. They just disrupt you here, the 1-3-1, the half traps. Yeah. Those half traps, you only come halfway down the lane, can be as tougher than the hard trap, you see, because it's hard to make a pass.
Yeah, the ball has a hard time getting to the other side of the floor, and that's the whole idea of what they're doing right now, to keep the ball on the one side. And against the zone, you always want to reverse the ball, take it to the other side, and you can't do that with the way they're playing D right now.
There's hands everywhere.
There's the board, high, arcing shot, and then getting it out right away, and here it goes. Laying it in. Boy, it's that simple on the other end for Mark Ray. When Malik Gantz gets the rebound and just tosses it. 6 points in the game for Ray. Give two in your heart there to Gantz.
Is that an assist and a rebound again?
Yes, it was. And again, you can fast break out of that zone a lot easier sometimes than you can man-to-man.
Another long look. Banks open. Knocking it down is Conway.
Saturday night in the Banks Open.
Yeah, I know. It's late tonight. It wasn't even a drive-through. 5 points in the game for Conway, 50-37. Still hanging around right now with 5:35 to play, within 13.
Yeah, again, a big possession here.
And it's going to go over the top. So
they got the stop.
Lancaster Catholic with a chance to get it back to 10 here, conceivably. As back into the game comes Gonzalez. They're doing a little offense, defensive stuff here.
Well, I think Lancaster Catholic can get back in this game because Bishop McDevitt is not going to slow down their tempo. They're going to allow them more possessions, enough possessions. Some teams would just eat the clock right now.
Yeah, I don't think that's going to happen. They're going to have to.
They're also not going to quit trapping. They turn it around right there, get another turnover. That's turnover number 15 against the Lancaster Catholic Crusaders. We got a timeout called by Bishop McDevitt, and Mike Gavin will take one as well. It's 50-37, 5:23 to go in this one on High School Sports Live TV on ABC 27.
HoffmanFord.com, turning the World Wide Web into the worldwide wow. Find the newer pre-owned Ford you want right now from your computer. Shop online 24/7, 365. And our exclusive inventory is updated daily. With hundreds of new and used vehicles, you're sure to find the one that clicks. Hoffman Ford, Harrisburg's premium Ford dealer for 60 years. Click on or come by.
There are players who make such a difference to your team. His name's Malik Gantz, number 22. You see the steal, the dunk there. And watch how many different ways. Here it is again from another angle. That's called a deposit. We said the bank's open. That's an early deposit there tonight. Now Gantz gets it inside, turns around. Watch this, just easy layup. He's blocked shots tonight. He's got 8 rebounds so far. Gantz so far in the ball game tonight. 10 points in this one, but it seems he's had such a great effect. They always say great players are the ones who make everybody around him better, Warren.
Well, like I said before, he's a great passer, finds the open man, and his teammates appreciate that, believe me. They'll play hard for him because he knows he'll find them.
How about James Williams on the post up that time with a turnaround high bank shot? He's got 6. Stretch it back out to 15. Just what it looked like. Lancaster Catholic might have a chance to get back into this one, get a little closer. Now got to get a jump ball, and the ball belonged to Bishop McDevitt.
Where there was quickness and aggressiveness defensively around that ball.
Well, they're still in that little half-court trap in the corners, trap out front, and that disrupts. Sometimes you can't really run an offense against that. You just have to spread the floor and make basketball plays.
Well, you can't get comfortable. You never get comfortable.
Like Jeff, you said before the game, they showed a lot of different defenses tonight.
Hopkins,
and they played
shot.
Them all well, too.
Williams with a good rebound. Good takeaway, though, from Plazas. It's the 11th turnover of the night against Bishop McDevitt. There again, the thing is, they challenge you all the time. There's never a sit-back moment. You can't take a breather when you play them, and it's going to wear on you, especially at this part of the game.
Well, when you're denying the next pass like they are and you can't throw it to somebody, you have to make a one-on-one move. And that's where it's, are you better than me, comes in. I'm guarding you, but I think I'm better than you, and that's what McDevitt's doing right now.
Nice shot by Gonzalez off the baseline, and Gonzalez with his 12th point of the evening.
Gonzalez is better than a lot of players, I can tell you that right now.
He's been impressive tonight, but he's also been saddled with fouls that have made him a little less effective than I think he might have been otherwise. Pick and roll play. Just another good play. Again, Gantz involved. Pick and roll. Mark Ray, the beneficiary, this time with 8 points in the game.
It appears that McDevitt's only Achilles heel is maybe indifference and nonchalance, because they do everything else really well.
Yeah, they certainly are going to be making a statement in the playoffs, I believe.
If they're ready to play, they're gonna be a tough out.
You know, it's interesting, though. You remember last year, there's another team in the Keystone there called Susquehanna Township.